it. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a Texas court on Monday halted next week's scheduled execution of convicted murderer Rodney.
Clark County paramedics responded to a frantic 911 call from a nearby motel this morning, where the Lord our God, divine creator and ruler of the universe, had been found nude and unconscious following his latest suicide attempt. God, who sources say had recently grown far more depressed and withdrawn from humanity than usual, reportedly attempted to hang himself from the base of his motel showerhead after ingesting an unknown quantity of Ambien. Motel sources claim that God's room had been left in a state of disarray and revealed that they had found a brief note written by the omnipotent deity, saying that the suicide stems from long periods of unhappiness he had been suffering in recent millennia, including the death of his only child, thousands of years of war and genocide, chronic weight gain, and the aftermath of his messy 15,088 BC divorce. Paramedics say the Supreme Being had no pulse when they arrived. The Lord's overdose comes in the wake of several widely publicized previous suicide attempts, including a 1985 incident when the Lord leapt from the Grand Canyon but changed into a bird at the last second and flew to safety.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, dial on in toll free to bring up whatever you'd like. 855-450-FREE, that is 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out to us that way if you don't mind, actually, because generally you'll sound better if you're using Skype. With you in the studio tonight, you have me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
And so, Mark, should we start with the bad news or the good news tonight?
I like good news. Let's start with the good news.
Here's some good news, and Rich, you'll appreciate this one. Reuters.com reporting from Juneau, Alaska, where smoking, growing, and owning small amounts of marijuana has become legal in Alaska as of today, as a growing decriminalization movement has reached the United States Northwest frontier. But this is more than decriminalization. This is actually legalization. Alaska, which narrowly passed the measure in November, followed Colorado and Washington among states allowing recreational use, reflecting a rapidly shifting legal landscape for the drug. It remains illegal, however, under federal law. In the District of Columbia, Mayor Muriel Bowser said on Tuesday the U.S. Capitol would go ahead with legalized possession of small amounts of marijuana and pot plants despite opposition from Congress. Voters overwhelmingly approved legal. I don't know how they can do that.
I want D.C. to secede. What happens if they secede?
Now, Rich Paul, I mean, you went to jail for selling cannabis, so this is an issue near and dear to your heart, certainly.
I hate it when that happens.
Yeah, and I'm surprised by this because I had heard that D.C. passed legalization, but that all laws in D.C. have to go through Congress where they can be blocked. So I would like to know more about how it is the mayor in D.C. is saying they can go ahead with this, even though Congress is opposing
something
it.
Something that they did and something that we can do on the city level in Keene, in cities in New Hampshire, possibly, is the Ann Arbor, Michigan, before I was born, passed a law against marijuana possession that carried a $5 fine as its only possible penalty.
Yeah.
It was automatic, like a parking ticket. And it forbade, although the state law remained on the books and could be enforced in Ann Arbor by the state police were never in Ann Arbor. And the Ann Arbor Police Department was basically by policy forbidden to enforce the marijuana statute on the state level. They were not allowed discretion. They were told, no, if you run across marijuana possession, you will charge it under the $5 fine for the city ordinance. And that's within a city's discretion to instruct its police force on what they should do without changing the law.
But DC's not your average city.
No.
Everything they do has to go through Congress. Now, they did decriminalize.
But congressmen don't vote in D.C. And still, remember that the real villains of our government only number some 544 people, including Supreme Court. I could be wrong on the math. Somebody check
it. That sounds right. 535.
I'll alter my definitions until the math is right. I'm not proud.
No, I think you're right.
Okay, cool.
Well, those are certainly some of the worst criminals, but there are plenty more criminals.
The problem with sort of bringing down, decriminalizing marijuana to $5, a $5 ticket or whatever, is that businesses can't open up and bring people things like pot brownies and, the pot lollipops and the pot sodas and whatever it is that they've got in these businesses in Colorado and Washington, is that these businesses are able to, you know, bring things to people that they wouldn't be able to get otherwise. I'm not claiming it's bad.
But at the cost of carrying a regulatory structure.
It's true.
You know, I would like to see the laws just wiped off the books. But if the choice is between a regulatory structure and a $5 fine for possession, if that $5 fine for possession goes up to any level, then I would say it's better to have a $5 fine than a regulatory. And
I agree.
You know, I think it may well be that a lot of cops would do what they did in Ann Arbor, which is not even write the ticket
because they
felt it was an embarrassing waste of time to be writing $5 tickets to people for marijuana possession.
Would they confiscate the product?
If they wrote you a ticket, they would confiscate
it. But if not, would they confiscate?
Generally.
And is this still in effect in Ann Arbor, or was this only for a short period
of time? It's up to $25 now.
Okay.
But it's still, and given inflation, that's about the same as $5 then. I'm old.
So I do actually have another article about D.C., but just to talk a little bit more about what's happening in Alaska, this was approved in 2014's election, and it is in effect now, as of today.
Oregon?
Yes, okay. Oregon voters did approve a similar measure.
At this point, every state in the West Coast...
Uh-huh.
Not California. They have medical.
Okay. They have a really interesting lax medical.
Don't they have medical plus decrim?
No, it didn't go through. Well, there might be some decrim, but the legalization measure did not go through.
Okay, so it's medical, but you can basically say, oh, I get headaches to your doctor. And you're like, there's chiropractors and, I don't know, woo-woo practitioners that can handle these things.
It's not hard to get pot in California. That's certainly true.
It's... I would call it de facto legalized in California.
Fair enough.
And so that's the whole West Coast.
That's correct.
Here's the challenge that I have, and I'd like to see New Hampshire do this, but just think about this. Some state in the East, Colorado, Washington, they've got the jump on the other places because people can go in and they can buy marijuana. You can't
go to California. That's a big boon for their economy.
It's a huge boon. Colorado, I believe the numbers were like 140 plus million in tax revenue and
last year
60 million in tax revenue and 140 million plus in savings on enforcement.
Yeah.
So they made $200 million by legalizing.
And they're not even counting tourism.
I think they're counting tourism, yes, in that, because that would be the tax revenue from the sales.
There would be tour. I'm talking about people staying in hotels, people using transportation services. You know, a lot of stoners have vacationed in Colorado.
It's absolutely true. There is cannabis tourism in Colorado and Washington State.
Rich is absolutely right. Add hundreds of millions of dollars more for the economy and then extra taxes on
and
top of that.
That's better money because it actually goes to the private sector mostly instead of going to the government.
And so, you know, hey, some state in the East... You are missing out. You're really, really dropping the ball on this.
Well, apparently Maryland does have some sort of effort going forward in their legislature. Of course, I've heard Vermont is talking about a legalization.
Vermont is going to steal this from New Hampshire.
Oh, yeah, they are.
And
it
is going to be so sad that the stuffy old people that run the House in New Hampshire just can't pass this. They really, really are dropping the ball. The governor is the reason, because she keeps on getting in bed with the police unions.
Yeah. See, it should be a Republican issue, and how it ended up being a Democratic issue, I don't know. It's so obvious. Small government, 10th Amendment. There are so many reasons that the Republicans should be leading the charge to to legalization, and except for Rand Paul, they're dropping the ball.
I don't think Rand Paul's not even very good on it.
He's not great on it. He does say he wants to end the war on drugs.
Has he said that?
Yeah. He's somewhat cagey about
I think it depends on
where,
who he's talking
when,
to.
And how. And that may be. I think Rand Paul plays the game much better than his father does, which makes it kind of anybody's guess what he really believes. Mm. And I'd be really curious to see what he did in office.
Well, we're going to come back with more on this. There's more to say about Alaska. Especially, I want to know what's going on with D.C. because they definitely did, the Congress did block the legalization measure that happened there. It was a voter-approved measure, and they didn't like it in Congress. Now, there was a decrim measure also that went through. Last year, they did decriminalize in D.C. because Congress left that one alone. So that one passed the city council, a decrim measure, and Congress ignored it. But they did not ignore the legalization one. We'll come back with more here in moments on what's happening with cannabis across the country. 855-450-FREE plus. When's Oregon going to implement their legalization? There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live. Share your thoughts.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. The Constitution was not America's first governing document. The first was the Articles of Confederation, created in 1775, under which the existing states grouped themselves as a union. Under the Articles, votes by the 13 states had to be unanimous, and what was enacted didn't have the force of law. It was merely a suggestion to the state. The Constitution's supporters, the Federalists, argued that the Articles were weak because the nation couldn't make good on its debts or prevent squabbles among states. Be careful what you wish for, their opponents, the Anti-Federalists, warned. A more powerful federal government could dominate the states and people. The Anti-Federalists lost that battle and the new Constitution was ratified. But it is in large part thanks to them that we have a Bill of Rights, the first 10 amendments to the Constitution adopted to address their concerns. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited toll free to dial in here. Bring up anything you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We'd also like to invite you to Austin, Texas, the downtown Moody Theater. Second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference will be happening there March 28th and 29th. So there's going to be some great keynote speakers, including George Gilder, who is a world-famous investor, economist, and author. Plus, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology, Sumbala Nair, will be flying in from India, as well as other great speakers, including Vitalik Buterin, Robert Murphy, Jason King, David Johnston, and Charlie Shrem. Go and get the full list over at TexasBitcoinConference.com. The real reason to come out to these conferences is the networking, to meet the people, the movers and the shakers in the Bitcoin universe. A lot of them are going to be there at Texas Bitcoin.
And to see the new tech.
Yeah, absolutely. TexasBitcoinConference.com, March 28th and 29th. Use code FTL, like Free Talk Live. Code FTL gets you $25 off the already very affordable $150 ticket price. And another $25 when you use code FTL will go to Sean's Outpost, which is an excellent Bitcoin-based charity that helps homeless people in North Florida. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Free Talk Live was there broadcasting live last year, and we had a great time. I'm definitely looking forward to going again, and we'll see you there March 28th and 29th. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Don't forget to use code FTL for the $25 off. We were just talking about Alaska. The story is from Reuters, where according to the story here, Tuesday, that's today, Alaska's legalization program has gone into effect for legalizing cannabis, as well as pot plants, so you can grow, you can possess, and I guess if you have the appropriate permission slip from government, you can sell it. According to the story,
that is the biggest problem, but I just don't see it undoing itself. I would also caution.
You don't see what undoing what self? I'm sorry.
Okay, I don't see that I don't see marijuana becoming legalized without the government getting a piece.
Well, that's what legalization entails. We discussed this last week, Mark, and I don't think you were on that show. But Rich Paul, you and I, and I forget who else was in here at the time, but Chris Cantwell, actually.
Yeah, Cantwell.
We came to the conclusion that we should be calling what we want, that the ideal circumstance for a true liberty-minded person should be considered repeal of prohibition.
Yes.
Not legalization, not decriminalization. Those are okay. Those are better than prohibition. But the best is total repeal of prohibition, the striking of the words cannabis from any statutes.
Yeah, and I don't think the politicians are going to go anywhere near that. I mean, it's like, do you guys want a bunch of money or not want a bunch of money? You know, that's what you're asking them here, and that's really the difficulty we have.
Well, the bottom line is it becomes a different issue. Once you get to the point where marijuana has a regulatory apparatus that's pretty much the same as what it has for alcohol.
In fact, the proposal is usually to use the Liquor Commission for it.
Yeah, then at that point, further legalization of marijuana is not more important to me or less important to me than further legalization of alcohol and further legalization of tobacco. So it becomes, there's no longer a war on marijuana. That's over. So that's good. And at that point, I would start saying, let's get rid of all of these regulatory apparatus.
Let's get rid of the Liquor Commission entirely. I was actually in the state house a couple few weeks ago, and there was a proposal on the table to repeal one of the regulations to make it so you don't have to have. There's in New Hampshire, there is a rule that says if you're going to sell alcohol, and by the way, only you can only sell beer and wine without being the government in New Hampshire. So if you're going to sell beer and wine, that you have to have $3,000 worth of food inventory. And this can be, you know, Spam. It can be canned food. It can be dried milk. And usually that's what these stores, these kind of beer and wine stores will do, is they'll, you know, have some really crappy Spam and stuff like that. And it'll be over in a corner just collecting dust because nobody actually goes to the beer and wine store to buy food. It's just some ridiculous requirement they put in there to make it more difficult to start a business.
Yeah, they say things like old people will starve if they don't have, if beer and wine stores don't have Spam. I mean, it's really ridiculous.
Well, no, they actually admitted. The liquor commissioner in the in his testimony actually did admit that their fear was that if they got rid of this $3,000 requirement, that all of a sudden these beer and wine stores will be popping up everywhere. They'll be on every street corner. This was what they believed. And, of course, it's unrealistic. $3,000 isn't a...
$3,000 isn't a hurdle to anything.
Yeah, it's nothing. I mean, it's you're going to have to spend $200,000 or whatever to open up that storefront. $3,000 is, you know, a drop in the bucket these days. Maybe when it was instituted decades ago, $3,000 would have been a little bit more of a hefty fee.
Well, I think what they don't want to admit is the people who really pushed for that $3,000, I'm told, are the grocery distributors.
This is true.
You know,
they were just there, actually.
Oh, they were there testifying for it again.
That's right.
Did they manage to say anything but, we really want the money?
No, that's what they said. They said it's going to hurt our business.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
It's amazing to me that a special pleading like that is not an argument for repealing the law. I mean, when people just come out and say, give us money because we want it, you know,
that's why I did.
They
I
are the grocery stores, right? Like they have this sort of we sell milk and eggs and cheese. We love you and your family. We're good people, and you don't want us to not get. I mean, there's a lot of money in fermented grape juice,
right?
And fermented wheat juice, or whatever the heck you'd call beer. And we don't want these little stores that all they do is sell the naughty stuff. They don't sell any of the wholesome things. Where are their damn bell peppers, for God's sake?
Yeah, they didn't go that far, Mark, but that might have actually been more persuasive had they made that argument. They could have said, we'll put these kids out of work if you get rid of this requirement.
The grocery stores of New Hampshire can hire me to shill for them. I'll be happy to go in there.
So this is one of those things. I know we've gotten off the cannabis legalization. We'll come back
So this is what I want to point out is that, A, licenses the government making something illegal and then selling you the right to do it again. Okay, selling you the ability. Taking away a right, selling you the ability to do it again. Secondarily, let's take a look at alcohol prohibition. It was legal. They made it illegal. And then they did this licensing thing.
Right.
And anybody who knows anything about alcohol licenses knows that it is messed up. There's a reason the mob's involved.
Oh, yeah. They restrict the number of licenses that are available in most places. And it's very difficult to acquire them. And you've got to go through background checks and all kinds of nonsense. So when I got up to testify on this bill of repealing that $3,000 requirement, I made the statement that this bill doesn't go far enough. We need to repeal the Liquor Commission entirely. So I actually told them that during my testimony. And the funny thing was, the next week, Chris Cantwell and I are sitting in the cafeteria in New Hampshire. You can actually eat with the state reps. You know, they talk to you. And so we're just sitting there having our chat during our lunch. And this state rep comes over and he introduces himself to Chris and I. And he essentially says, he kind of joked with me, like, you should have seen the look on the liquor commissioner's face, because the head of the liquor commission came out to testify in favor of this $3,000 requirement. And he was apparently sitting right behind me when I advocated for the complete repeal and elimination of the liquor commission. This state rep says to us, you should have seen the look on his face. It was priceless. And
wow.
So, you know, that was
there nobody filming?
I think there was...
That actually was before we started bringing the camera on a more consistent basis.
We need more activists out there.
And it probably wouldn't have caught the camera probably wouldn't have caught the audience reaction anyway. But I just thought it was an interesting story.
Yeah,
and
that,
you know,
is great.
That doesn't happen everywhere. Only in New Hampshire, I think. 855-450-FREE. If you want to join the fun, come on up here and check out the Liberty Forum. We'll tell you more about that here in a little bit. And definitely go to freestateproject.org if you love liberty. There's more Free Talk Live coming up.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
If you're looking for work, there's a piece of paper more important than your resume. It's the cover letter attached if you're snail mailing or the email to which you attach your resume. Make it four short paragraphs. Paragraph one, say that you're applying for work. The person you're sending to gets a ton of mail about all sorts of things. If you have a password, that's your first sentence. Tom Nelson tells me you and I should meet. Paragraph 2, what you do and how that relates to the opening. Be as specific as possible. Paragraph 3, why you want this particular job. I'm originally from Boston, so I know the market well. I have family and friends in the area, so this would be a homecoming for me. Paragraph 4, unless the job posting stipulates no calls, and I will call you to follow up. Thank you in advance for your time. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
Do you guys have a zombie plan? I'm just wondering what this country's going to do if we had some sort of apocalypse like that.
Like a
what
zombie
are we
attack.
Gonna do?
People coming
yeah,
out
like
of the ground, like in Thriller,
or,
like in Michael Jackson's Thriller.
No, like 28 days later, like a virus or something.
Oh, okay.
I mean, people don't come back to life.
Well, now, there are different kinds of zombies out there.
Now,
but let me go through the types of zombies. I mean, you've got the ones that can crawl out of the ground, right? And then she was talking about like an infection kind of zombie, mm-hmm. like a la Resident Evil, for instance. So ideally, if you're going to have to perish at the hands of a zombie, which would be the preference? Would you prefer to have your brains eaten, or would you prefer to become one of them?
I think I'd rather just die.
Yeah.
The last thing I'd want is, of course, the people you split up with. Then I'm talking my wife and my child. I'm coming back. I'm wanting to eat Laura's brains. It's bad.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. How about some free coffee? How about a pound of some of the best coffee out there in the world from BuzzBox. Shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica. You get your first pound free. Just pay the shipping cost. How do you do it? You go to coffee.freetalklive.com and get signed up. Now, you can cancel your subscription at any time, but the folks over at BuzzBox are so confident that you will not want to cancel. That's why they're giving you an entire pound to try it out. So go to coffee.freetalklive.com to get started there. And know this, that when you buy coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, a portion of the sale is going towards microloans through kiva.org. We're giving loans out to people in tough parts of the world in which to live and helping them make a better life for themselves. So you can get great coffee and help people out as well. So go to coffee.freetalklive.com. Back with you in studio, it's Ian here with you.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
Rich Paul looking super cool. If you are watching our cam right now at cam.freetalklive.com, you'll see he is wearing sunglasses indoors at night.
From a storage unit.
Let's go to Robert. He's in Bellows Falls. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Robert.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Hey, I got a quick question, and then I got just a comment I want to make.
Okay, sure.
Rich, I wanted to ask you, when we go full on legal over here, would you come over and celebrate with all of us?
Where are you?
Vermont.
I'll definitely come party with you guys. I won't move. I'm committed to the Free State Project, but I will definitely come smoke a bowl of blunt and whatever other sort of paraphernalia you can muster.
Great. I'm looking forward to it.
What's happening over there, Robert? Anybody? What's the status? Have you been following the Vermont legalization movement?
It's my understanding that the company is all done in terms of some kind of an evaluation, and that's all done. And it sounds like to me that they're just waiting to vote on this. Is what it sounds like to me. I could be wrong.
So is this like a consulting group that came in and like did a study on how much money they were going to be able to extract out of people from a tax? Is that what happened?
They're saying that when it goes full on legal over here, that the state of Vermont will make tens of millions of dollars in tax revenue. It's going to, surpass, according to what it said in the paper, Colorado, Washington, and wherever else it's legal. And I can see that happening because, obviously the state of New Hampshire is beside Vermont. Maine, Massachusetts, New York. I mean, it's gonna be incredible to see this. It's really kind of exciting.
Yeah, I agree with you. Robert, thanks for the call, man. I appreciate it. Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Someone on the East Coast state is going to go first, and the only question is which one.
It's going to put a tremendous amount of pressure on the surrounding states.
Oh, yeah,
You can go from, New Hampshire, which sadly, I'm really sorry to say this, has the most draconian pot laws in New England.
It's true.
If you can go from New Hampshire and just drive over the border, I can see Vermont from my house.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sarah Palin.
Yeah, well, I got her tied up out back.
Damn.
I can go there and just, smoke up and then whatever. I mean, there's nothing they can do. It just throws it all into a tailspin for them. And the chief of police's organization, whatever that is, that goes and testifies in front of the New Hampshire House.
Yep.
He's just going to look like a braying jackass.
Oh, he's
up there
already
talking.
There. I mean,
there's video of that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not to the old people that populate the New Hampshire House, right?
Well, the New Hampshire House is right on this issue. I just like to make
that
clear.
Not right enough.
If they were
90% right, they would shove it through.
No. They had a veto-proof margin last time
this.
Yeah. The New Hampshire House has been right on this issue for a number of years.
Fine. Then the New Hampshire
Senate. The issue is the Senate, where this issue got tabled last year.
Well, really, it's the governor, because it went
and the governor
all the way through and got vetoed. Yeah. And then
no,
came
it didn't
back.
Go. It didn't get
well. The scuttlebutt has been that the Senate has been voting against it because they knew that
the governor
the governor would veto it, and they didn't want her to have to do that. So they're complicit in her scheme, no matter what it is.
Now, it is a different makeup of the Senate this year. Maybe things will have a better chance. Maybe decrim will have a better chance. We'll see. I mean, you can't really predict in advance what's going to happen. But one of the And one of the things that is true about New Hampshire is the government is in such a way here that it is difficult to change, which means it's difficult to get rid of things that are already there, but it's also difficult to add things to in New Hampshire. It's fairly challenging for the people who love the government, the status, if you will, for them to actually get their way. That's why New Hampshire has resisted having like a seatbelt law for adults forever. I mean, we're the only state of the 49. New Hampshire's the only one, or 49 others have this.
The cantankerous Yankee sword cuts on both sides, sadly. And, you know, the as hard as it is to get a law through in New Hampshire is as hard as it is to get to repeal a law in New Hampshire.
But this one, I think, now look, I've been attending these hearings, and Rich, I know you've been to some of them as well, but these cannabis legalization slash decrim slash repeal hearings, I've been to many of these, and it's starting to sound more like an inevitability.
Yep.
And
it is an inevitability. Right. If any legislator who doesn't think it's an inevitability is a fool.
Yeah. I mean, they for a long time, the excuse was, the most common excuse you would hear would be, well, you know, all these things you're saying about legalization make sense because the legalization
crew
comes in there with all kinds of great information, well-researched. You know, they've got their presentation together. Normal's in there. You know, there's different organizations. And they put together a great presentation. And so the excuse used to be, oh, well, that's great and everything, and we understand what you're saying, but the federal government will come crack down on us. We can't legalize it because what will the feds do? Well, now we know they don't have that one.
Right. And I never understood that argument because the feds have never punished a state for failing to duplicate federal law at a state level.
But they have raided. But they have raided the medical facilities in California even after medical passed there.
Well, they have done it, but my answer to a legislator who brought that up would be, look, if the feds want to have a war on drugs, let the feds pay for it.
Well,
but there's no reason to be wasting New Hampshire blood and treasure on that.
So many of the old people want to fall in line. You know, before everything, they got to say a Pledge of Allegiance all that stuff. But what I'd like to point out is each and every one of the people that made that excuse is wrong. They're wrong. They haven't done it to Colorado. They haven't done it to Washington.
Right.
They're not going to do it to Alaska. They're not going to do it to Oregon. And they're not going to do it to D.C. because they were wrong, right? Like, this is what happens when you make these predictions is you never really know. And that prediction was wrong.
Right. So that one's off the table. That was their biggest excuse. That was the biggest argument they had. Well, we could do it, but... Well, now that one's off the table, so they are they're running out of excuses. I mean, at this point, the only real argument they have is to trot out the state police.
We don't want the extra tax money, and we'd like to give it all to Vermont. We're a bunch of fools that hate our state.
They just trot out look, I was at the most recent hearing, which was about decrim, actually, and the only people who opposed this was the state police, the same guy who's there every time. The chiefs of police organization, and it's the same, you know, white haired
guy I chased out of there one day.
Yeah, that's right. We got video of that. And this guy, the white haired guy, just submitted written testimony. He didn't even bother testifying because he knows the House is going to vote. You know, the House is going to vote for legalization. And so then the only other people who testified against it was this group called NH Futures, which is a prohibitionist group. They trotted out a couple high school girls who did some sort of I missed this part, but it is on video because I was out of the room. But from what I was told, they had a little script and they read from the script, and it was like a little trade off thing where one girl said one thing and the other girl said the other and the other girl said. And so they, you know, they just read off their propaganda. And then, of course, no one asked them any questions because, well, they didn't want to put them on the hot seat.
Why would you want some 16-year-old's opinion?
So it's just, I mean, that's all they've got is the children.
See, that's what the porcupine legislators should answer that tactic with. They should start asking these kids sophisticated questions.
Oh, I agree. The toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. But let's come back around to Alaska because that's the third state to legalize. It went into effect today. We'll talk a little bit more about what's included in that coming up on Free Talk Live.
Kid, let me paint you a picture. Tuesday night, your cog belt goes bust. Who will help you get what you need fast? Without the hoops, hurdles, or headaches? Granger, that's who. I love Granger. They got a wide variety of products and solutions. Granger makes it easy to get everything we need and answers for when we're not sure what the answer is. Now, kid, let me paint you another picture. It looks like a mop, a basement bathroom, and you all over it. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com or stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
you ought to go.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared me.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency, and Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, and spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here to bring up whatever you'd like at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I mentioned earlier tonight the Liberty Forum. If you love the ideas of freedom and you like the idea of the Free State Project, the idea of bringing liberty-minded people together to the same geographic area, that's what the Free State Project is about. 20,000 is the number that we're trying to reach. We've got over 16,000 today. And so when we reach 20,000 people who are signing up and pledging to make the move to New Hampshire, then the move will officially begin. Now, the three of us, we're early movers.
What's the official number on that? How many movers exactly?
Movers, I believe, is probably around 1,500. There are about 1,700 people who are here in New Hampshire. And then as far as the number of actual signers, it's been a while since I've looked, but I can pull that up. All the information you need is over at freestateproject.org. And current number of participants, 16,474. That's the number of signers, and then the number in New Hampshire already is 1,709, which means that we've got a good solid 10% of the membership that are already here, and they're getting started, and some of them have gotten elected. And we were talking about legalizing cannabis, and of course, if you want to see cannabis decriminalized, legalized, the prohibition repealed, I still think New Hampshire's the best place to go because it's going to happen here eventually, and then you get all the other benefits of being in the freest place in the United States.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to go visit Colorado, but sure. Colorado is less free in so many ways.
Yeah, gun freedoms aren't the same there.
Yeah.
Well, if you go, and the Mercatus Center has checked it out, the freedom of in the 50 states, and New Hampshire has ranked number one 3 out of the 5 times, and five times in the top 5 freest state in the union. So New Hampshire is sort of inarguably the freest state when you look at those, certain the Mercatus Center's listing. There's another one that came out recently, but it doesn't seem to be as in-depth. And, that makes sense. Now, if pot's important to you, I think that you're going to see that that most states are going to switch over relatively quickly.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of an avalanche happens, right? Because certainly medical, there's, 22, 24 states or something like that?
They claim more than half.
Yeah, there's quite a few states that have gone medical, and of course more go that way over time. Will we see legalization go faster than medical? Because remember, it was 1996.
So, but I don't know.
It was 1996 when California went with its Proposition 215, which legalized medical. So that's almost 20 years to get to 25 states.
I think that the last states will just go straight to decrim or regulation skip medical, and I don't think they'll go as far as repeal. That's going to be a future battle.
So hopefully we'll see repeal here in New Hampshire at some point, but we've got to get activists
that
here.
Would be nice if we were the first state to have repeal. That would give the Liberty Crown back to New Hampshire.
Well, also something that could happen. And again, I'm not predicting that New Hampshire will do this, but it could happen that New Hampshire could be the first legislative legalization or whatever. Because I know New Hampshire was the first state to have legislative gay marriage, for instance. So it wasn't the first state with gay marriage, but it was the first to do it through the legislative process, which is a fairly difficult thing to accomplish if you think about it.
And there is no, unfortunately, no ballot proposition system in New
Maybe
Hampshire.
Not so unfortunate, because you could argue that there's a lot of bad stuff that comes through the ballot measures as well. Like in Florida, when we started Free Talk Live in 2002, the very first issue that we talked about was the smoking ban that was put on the ballot in Florida and passed by 70% margin there. I mean, there was a tremendous amount of people. These guys in Florida, they'll vote for everything they put on the ballot. The people down in Florida will just vote yes on every single ballot measure. I mean, I swear to you.
Wow.
So, yeah, I kind of feel like having the ballot measure thing is not necessarily a good thing.
Oh, you may well be right.
Well, especially when you have the very representative kind of structure that New Hampshire has. Now, I'm under no delusion that a so-called representative represents me. That's obviously not the case. It is what it is. But
there are people in the legislature that do represent me, though, and this is the first time I've ever been able to say that. I mean, I can't say that Mark Warden doesn't represent me. I can't say Kyle Tasker doesn't represent me. Or
there might be a couple issues on which we would quibble, but I tend to agree with you there. But
nobody represents me exactly.
That's
I
mean.
If you put 100 anarchists in a room together,
somebody's going to throw a Molotov cocktail.
Well, they might, but there's going to be 101 opinions on any given issue.
But my point being that
that's why I never use that term.
In New Hampshire, these so-called representatives, they represent around 3,000 people per district because there are 400 representatives in New Hampshire. So it's just a totally different situation here, and I don't think you even need ballot measures here at all. So back to the story here from Alaska. By the way, Mark, I pulled up the Mercatus Center, Freedom in the 50 States. From 2014, I think this is.
So New Hampshire's at number 3 on that one?
New Hampshire is at number 4
on that one. Okay.
And Colorado is number 19. So not even close. All right, back to the story about Alaska, which sparked this entire conversation. They do mention here that Oregon voters approved a similar measure in November, but the drug does not become legal there until July. In Maryland, the state legislature began hearings on Tuesday on a measure to legalize marijuana. It's also happening in Vermont and New Hampshire, but whether those will go anywhere is another question. In Alaska, anyone age 21 or older can possess up to an ounce of marijuana and can grow up to six plants, three of which can be flowering. Smoking in public and buying and selling the drug remains illegal, but private exchanges are allowed if money is not involved. Now, that's interesting.
Now, could you use Bitcoin? Isn't Bitcoin considered a commodity?
It depends who you ask.
Yeah, I would not give you legal advice on that.
Okay.
Barack Obama's Department of Justice has allowed the experiments to proceed, saying it would look to prosecute a narrower range of marijuana-related crimes, such as sales to children. But that could change if a more conservative president is elected in 2016, when Alaska's first marijuana shops are likely to open. Supporters of the measure say it reflects... So basically, today, Tuesday, when we're recording this show... It is legal for you to possess up to an ounce of marijuana, and you can grow up to six plants. The stores will not open until sometime in 2016. So this is sort of a tiered introduction into legalization. So kind of this is sort of like a decrim period, essentially, where or almost a semi-repeal, at least for a short period of time, in that it's fully legal to possess this. There is not a criminal penalty.
Up to an ounce.
Fully legal to possess.
Now, the question is, at what point, if ever, does it become a felony? Because as long as there's still felonies on the books involving marijuana, that's pretty ugly.
Yeah. Well, it's not perfect.
No.
But
nothing is.
Supporters of the measure say it reflects a sense of personal freedom that resonates with residents of Alaska, a state with a libertarian streak. This is, again, the Reuters story. They also say legal sales will generate income and jobs. Dr. Tim Hinterberger, chairman of the campaign to regulate marijuana like alcohol, said in the statement, quote, Alaska now has some of the most sensible marijuana laws in the nation, unquote. The state's school alcohol regulatory board, which is set to meet on Tuesday, must fill gaps in the legislation, such as a definition of the public places where people cannot light up. So again, smoking in public is illegal. Buying and selling cannabis is illegal. State regulators are drafting rules covering the taxation and sale of marijuana, which must be adopted by November 24th. Applications for the first business licenses will not be accepted until February 2016. So if they're not accepting applications for licenses until February, you can expect they likely won't be opening their doors on any businesses until the summer of 2016 at the earliest, I would say, in Alaska.
I wonder what the policy will be on private clubs.
Excellent question. Don't have an answer for you there. But if you're in Alaska and you can answer Rich's question, you can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. Now, why did you ask that question? What is the relevance there?
Because, you know, the thing that you want once you have legal weed is someplace where you can hang out with it at a bar, similar to a bar, maybe just a cannabis bar. But... you know, that's an important part of freedom.
I totally agree. I was in Toronto, and they had these semi-tolerated places. So it was still illegal what was going on in these places, but the police weren't doing anything about it, generally. Every now and then they'd crack down on one of them. I don't know, maybe they weren't paying their bribes or something like that, but there were these places where you could go, bring your own marijuana, and the place would provide a vaporizer and basically kind of a chill pad where, you know, they'd have a video game system, DVDs, a television, and, you know, people could just hang out and get high. And they actually sold marijuana milkshakes at this place, along with some sandwiches and some snacks and goodies like that. It was a $14 milkshake, and boy, was it good. More coming up here.
You know, he remembers
that
price.
That's worse than Pulp Fiction.
Free Talk Live. There's more coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, February 24th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,193, down $10. Silver opened at $16.22, down 13 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $237.50. Today's precious metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, officials with the International Atomic Energy Agency have stated they will consider re-examining alleged evidence of Iran's nuclear capability after details of a CIA operation have been exposed. The CIA is accused of sending fake blueprints for nuclear weapon components to Iran in February of 2000. Court documents reveal a plot to plant the substantial piece of deceptive information on the Iranian nuclear weapons program. An activist with St. Louis Anonymous is currently facing 3 years in jail for five charges, including two counts of interfering with an officer following arrest in Ferguson, Missouri. Alex Poucher says he's being targeted for his role in protests and online actions by the Anonymous Collective against St. Louis police. In honor of the launch of the new and improved SovereignLiving.com, the Liberty Beat each day this week will bring you a simple survival tip that just might save your life. With today's tip, here's John Bush.
Maintain supplies and tools for lighting in a power outage. Power outages occur regularly, especially if you're in a part of the country with an antiquated electric system. Keep a plentiful supply of candles and matches around. Kerosene lamps are good to have on hand as well, but be sure you stock enough kerosene to get you through a lengthy blackout. Keep several flashlights around along with a solid supply of batteries. Flashlights are good to use when you need to navigate a dark hallway or check on your property.
The Liberty Beat is brought to you by the Free State Project. Want to find liberty in your lifetime? Then join thousands of others who are making the move to New Hampshire, the freest state in the Union. To learn more or to pledge to move today, visit freestateproject.org. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, February 24th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The U.S. Customs and Border Protection has revealed which cities will begin pilot programs for body cameras. Cameras are being used in New Mexico, West Texas, Florida, Washington, Oregon, and Michigan. The cameras are being implemented in response to growing backlash to use of force by Border Patrol officers and agents. Since January 2010, there have been 39 deaths at the hands of the Border Patrol, with 2014 being the most violent year. The American Civil Liberties Union called for the agency to adopt the cameras as far back as October of 2012. Both the Houston, Texas Police Department and the Harris County, Texas Sheriff's Office are refusing to release details about their policies on how body cameras will be turned on or off. The Houston Chronicle reports the requests from both departments have been denied. The Houston Police have spent around $108,000 on 100 cameras for a pilot program and are seeking $8 million to purchase cameras for 3,500 officers. On February 20th, the North Dakota State House approved a bill that would allow the farming, production, and sale of industrial hemp. House Bill 1436 was passed with a vote of 87-5 and now moves to the state Senate. If the measure passes, it would effectively nullify federal prohibition on industrial hemp. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets and to boost your returns through leverage. Learn more at CoinArch.com. Support also comes from My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, February 24th, 2015. Check out the website at TheLibertyBeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
This is The Onion Week in Review. Citing his erratic social behavior, nondescript occupation, and habit of accidentally walking off piers while pretending to read newspapers, acquaintances of 37-year-old Jeff Walther suspect he may be a bumbling spy. Residents of Worcester, Massachusetts are kind of hoping a Panera Bread will show up and plow over an obnoxious neighborhood bakery. Locals have said that the soulless restaurant chain, with its simple, impersonal experience, would be just the thing to help run the precious mom-and-pop establishment out of business.
Callahan's is really lovely and all, but it would be such a relief to have some college-aged kid take my order without making eye contact. I just need a cup of coffee. You know, we're not friends.
A follow-up survey of Worcester residents confirmed that 72% of patrons would rather be alerted of an order by a vibrating pager than a kind-faced woman who calls everybody sweetheart. In other news, feds break up a brutal Las Vegas man-fighting ring. A Christmas card ominously makes no mention of the twins. And the Boy Scouts celebrate 100 years of preparing teens for not having cool friends.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you can dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Alaska legalization, it's in effect. You can legally possess now, according to Reuters, up to an ounce of cannabis. You can also possess up to six cannabis plants. Three of the six may be flowering. Now, legal sales stores are not yet open. Stores are not allowed to sell until 2016. And there's going to be, an application phase that starts in February of 2016. And right now they're working on whatever regulations and nonsense that they're going to have to abide by in order to legally sell. So right now, while Rich Paul, you could, if you were in Alaska, possess an ounce of cannabis legally, you could not sell any of it. And you could not buy that ounce. So it's only legal to give someone cannabis, not to actually sell or purchase it at this point in Alaska.
It'll be an interesting experiment in the concept of the gift economy. I could imagine giving somebody an ounce of weed, and if they gave me an appropriate present in return, I might do it again one day. But if they failed to, of course, it's an expensive thing to find out, so you might want to give them a gram and see if they give you something appropriate, and give them a slice and see if they give you something appropriate. But what I want to know is, will you guys go with me so we can sit in Sarah Palin's backyard, smoke a fatty, and look across at the Kremlin?
As I understand, she never said that, just so you know.
She smoked a fatty?
No. She didn't say that she could see Russia from her backyard. That was whoever played her on Saturday Night Live, as I understand it.
Oh, okay.
I mean, it was such a good joke.
It's a that brilliant everybody joke.
She said
it's
it.
A brilliant, brilliant. Yeah, I love it.
And I didn't, you know, even when I heard it, I never sort of ascribed it to anything. I didn't think, you know, well, she's lying because I knew that she couldn't see Russia from her backyard. I thought what she was trying to say is look, you know, I'm from Alaska, and in Alaska we have different politics because we're located geographically different than other places. That's what I thought she meant by it. Huh. And I thought it was a fine statement.
Yeah,
but it's
I know.
Not. But she didn't say it.
I never
Alaska
heard any
was
about
my
it.
Second choice after New Hampshire for Free State Project.
It was number three for me. I chose Wyoming second.
Wyoming? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Alaska was number two for me. I chose Delaware first.
See, I was thinking secession, and Wyoming is so hopelessly landlocked that I didn't want it.
Yeah. I didn't think Wyoming was a good choice either. It's too wide and expansive. I figured that people, you know,
Alaska's pretty wide and expansive.
Yes,
too.
But not the people in it. If you start looking where population is that you know they're along they're the places that I would want to move in Alaska are warmer than the any place in New Hampshire.
Yeah. So really? We're talking about the vote for the Free State Project, which took place back in 2003. It's been 12 years now since that vote happened, and people have
12 years. Can you believe? Believe it? It seems
11 and a half. But yeah, we're almost to 12 years. And there are now, like we were talking about before, over 1,000 people, over 1,500 people who've moved here. You can go to freestateproject.org to learn more about what's happening. You know what? I started talking about the Liberty Forum in the last hour, and I never actually got to my point. We ended up getting sidetracked, I think, talking about the New Hampshire legislation or the legislative branch that is, you know, very accessible compared to other states. What I wanted to get out there was that Liberty Forum's coming up March 5th through the 8th, and I can get you a free ticket. If you're not yet a Free State Project signer, if you're not yet living in New Hampshire, and if you're willing to pledge to attend the FSP questions session at the Liberty Forum. Liberty Forum's a kind of a weekend-long hotel-based convention, hundreds of liberty-minded people, great name speakers. Patrick Byrne from Overstock.com is one of the keynote speakers this year. Jeffrey Tucker, Ben Swan will be a keynote speaker this year. So big name speakers.
They have all these speakers. I just always went and got messed up.
Yeah, well,
you can also party with the activists.
You can totally party, and yeah, that's absolutely true. It's a great time, and I recommend you check it out. But as I was saying, if you attend the FSP question session, if you will commit to attending that session on Saturday at 12:30, then I can get you a free ticket, so long as you meet the other two qualifications of not yet living in New Hampshire and not yet being a Free State Project signer. You just email me at ian@freetalklive.com, ian@freetalklive.com. Email me your name. Let me know you've pledged to make that one session, and you get a free ticket to the Liberty Forum March 5th through the 8th.
So I have a question about the Free State Project here. Given by Quiricus, and he says, do you guys
see email or instant
Queer
message?
Kiss?
This is just it's in a Facebook group, but I think it's worth asking because I think people ask this, and we believe so thoroughly that we never even ask ourselves this question. Do you guys think the FSP is fizzling out or building steam?
Oh, clearly
building steam.
Yeah, I think it is too.
The movers are picking up, and that's the proof in the pudding.
There's right, new mover parties in Manchester every single month, and there's a dozen or half a dozen new people at the very least that'll attend those parties, and those are just the ones who are attending that party. There are others who move and don't go to the party.
Yeah, we've got four new movers in Keene this month, and
that's unusual for Keene. Keene doesn't attract as many movers as quickly as Manchester does, but we do have some new movers here.
Yeah, so we're doing a party on the 28th for that.
And, well, what I would say is that I think that the Free State Project kind of was sort of mistaken in the way that it was set up. And here, let me defend that. Because
I think you're right about that.
Originally, they had shutdown period. If we don't get 20,000 signers by
2006.
Sometime in 2006, I can't tell you the date. Then it's over, right? And that didn't work out. They were maybe at half the signers, 10,000. I don't know what it was at that time.
I don't think so. Probably not even that much.
They were certainly over five because five was where they picked New Hampshire.
Correct.
Things dropped off dramatically once New Hampshire was picked. Once this fantasy...
9/11 was a big part of that, I think.
I don't... Maybe. To me, what it is that what I've seen by studying Move Here projects, and I have a Facebook page called The Move Here Project, and what it is that I think that there is this excitement in the fantasy of a bunch of libertarians moving to someplace, and that it's really about the fantasy. once they nail it down and people start moving, because people moved, you can probably go to the Free State Project's Liberty Forum here in March and see the first mover. She goes around and she often likes to tell people she's the first mover. Mm-hmm. I can't remember her name off the top of my head.
I think it's Jackie. And
yes, it is Jackie.
She's really awesome, and I think it must be great to be the first mover. I wish I could say it. But anyway, so
her plans were made to move here before the state was selected, actually.
Is that so? Nonetheless, she is the first mover for the Free State Project. God bless her soul. And, once people started moving, like Jackie, then the fantasy became a reality, and people are like, oh, I got to sell my house and I'm going to lose money on that. And, I've got these extra cars and I'm going to have to get a new job. And what about my mom and dad? They're getting older. And mm-hmm. all the things that moving, entails sort of started coming up. And I think that that's kind of what, did it in early on. And then they decided, well, we'll just extend the time frame to never ever. And then, we've continued to add signers and continued to add movers. 1,700 people moving for a Project for Liberty is...
It's about 1,500 that have moved. There were about 270 that were already in New Hampshire.
Are you sure
when the state was chosen?
That number is the in-state number? Or the
yeah.
is that the mover number?
It's about 270 were here.
Fine. 1,500...
I was in-state number 666.
If Ian was 420.
Nice.
Yeah. I'm 421.
Can we trade?
I don't know. What's it worth to you?
So, no, you cannot alter reality, gentlemen. Nonetheless, so, once people start, I've lost my train of thought, guys. Congratulations.
Moving. People moving.
All right. So, 1,500 people moving is more than any other project has ever had in the history of anything.
It's probably 10 times or, a lot
10 times,
more,
I'd say, is a fair number.
More.
Yeah. So, the Free State Project is unequivocally a success. Is it winding down or building up? Well, if movers and signers are an indication, then it is building.
How about elections? How about the Free State Project participants, over 15 of them, more than the last election, being elected in 2014?
I think it's a great indication, but a lot of people would say, working within the system only, blah, blah, blah. Right?
Oh, they're not going to move anywhere, so the hell with them.
Well, I'll tell you what, I was in Concord the other day, And James was wearing his Free Talk Live sweatshirt.
Oh, okay.
And somebody asked him about it, and we started talking about the show. And she said, oh, what party are you? And I said, Libertarian. And she said, did you move here for the Free State Project? It was this lady who works in a thrift store. And it's like, they can connect Libertarian mm-hmm. to something here. That's nice.
I'd say that you're absolutely wrong, Ian. People who work outside the system have moved for the Free State Project, and they're doing other things. And they're having whatever
but success
they're having.
Most of them that have these objections, they're not going to move. 855-450-FREE. More coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realists, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right. General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under $30,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet under $30,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait.
Call 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about decriminalization, legalization, the repeal of the cannabis laws and where it stands today, with Alaska being the latest state, the third state, to implement some form of legalization. It's good news and more good news to come, with Oregon being the next step. That's coming up this summer. Alaska will have stores being able to sell cannabis a little bit later on. That's going to be in 2016. So things are moving in the right direction. When's your state going to be jumping on board this bandwagon? The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I also said that we would talk about D.C. because there's an interesting situation that has been developing there in D.C., specifically the fact that voters approved legalization in November. However, Congress attempted to block the district from enacting the laws regulating the sale of the drug. We'll talk more about what's happening there. But first, let's go to your calls and thoughts. Mark in St. George, Utah, listening to KZNU. Hello, Mark.
Hello, yeah. It was unique that we're talking about the marijuana issue in Utah. It'll never pass here. But the Free State Project ideas do exist here. You need to say about moving to New Hampshire, there's no need to move anywhere. We already can make it happen in our neighborhood.
No, you can't.
How? I was on your program, yeah.
No, you can't.
And I talked on your program about how I was being blocked about running a business my own way through Craigslist and open social media. And then since then, that's gone away somehow. And my business has thrived.
Well, I certainly wouldn't, you know, I'm not going to dance on, you know, I'm happy as it could possibly be. I wouldn't rain on your parade on that one. But to claim that...
Well, there's a lot of bloggers who listen.
But to claim that you can be as successful as the Free State Project, which has gotten 15
No. By having the ideals that you guys give out there, I don't have to move to New Hampshire. You were talking about how many people moved to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, but what about the people who don't have to move anywhere, but the ideas are here in our neighborhood?
Well, certainly the ideals exist elsewhere. The problem is the density of people who believe those things is so low that in most chain... in most states, real change is pretty much impossible in a libertarian direction. But if we can get all the libertarians into one place...
They're not all going to come here, but a bunch of them
all.
Should.
And I don't want all of them, but...
What I was saying is that I mentioned that I had this problem in my neighborhood on your program, and thereby, things changed in my neighborhood. It might have been whatever you guys said, just like advertisers who are in between. That's fine. That's great. That's why I like your show. That's why I'm a listener. And I just want to give you a big thumbs up.
Well, I appreciate that. I'm not going to take credit for whatever the heck it is that happened in your neighborhood.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just giving you recognition for saying what you're saying on a national program because I like it because I also live it in my life.
Thanks, Mark. I appreciate the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. But this is one of the most common things that comes up about the Free State Project. We'll talk about D.C.'s legalization here in a moment. But one of the most common objections is, well, we don't need to move to New Hampshire. We can be free right here in state XYZ, whichever state you happen to physically be geographically
bounded. Why not 50 Free State Projects? This is another iteration of that.
And so the reason why
someone somewhere is completely missing the point.
Well, right. And this is the viewpoint of someone who has never done any activism. This is the viewpoint
or not done much. They could have done some activism and successful, like the gentleman, right? Like
he doesn't even know what happened. He just said that, we talked about his situation on the air and whatever was threatening him vaporized. So great. I'm glad that happened, but I'm not going to take credit for it. It was probably a coincidence or just being bureaucrats being lazy or whatever it was. But somebody who says, let's just have 50 free state projects or you should have it here in Alaska or in Alabama or whatever state you happen to be in. The reason why that's not going to cut it is because, the reason why the Free State Project was formed in the first place. We've tried this whole freedom in 50 states thing, and it doesn't work. There aren't enough libertarians, and there aren't going to be enough anytime soon. Not only are there not enough libertarians, but there are even fewer libertarians who are willing to lift a finger beyond their keyboard on Facebook to actually do something in real life, like, go and testify in front of a committee at the state house, or run for political office, or do civil disobedience, or something like that. They won't do anything except for complain about it on the internet or call talk radio. And I'm sorry, that's not going to be enough to make a difference.
I don't know that I agree
with
your assessment. Okay, so I would say I don't know how many libertarians there are. I think that if you ask people, are they fiscally conservative and socially liberal, you'll find that probably more than half of the people will say that that's the case, which would put them in the broader category of libertarian. However, libertarians tend, as a personality type, this broader group that I'm talking about, tend to not want to be involved in the government. They don't want the government's programs. They don't want to have to deal with the government. People who want to be involved in the government are people who like government. People who want the government to do this thing or that thing or all the things or whatever. Those people we call activists because they get involved with the government and they get the things that they want to get done. The voting public doesn't matter. What you think as a regular voting taxpaying citizen really doesn't matter. The fact is that your local and state governments are largely influenced by activists, and the larger your state government is, the more likely it is to be influenced by this other group of people we call lobbyists. Lobbyists are paid by people. Activists do it on their own. And the fact is that there are libertarian activists, but they just can't get anything done because they're drowned out by the lobbyists and the other activists, the statist activists. In New Hampshire, we actually have about as many currently activists as they've got on the other side. And this is incredibly powerful. Now, I'll admit many of the politicians to some extent discount what the activists say, the libertarian activists say, because they're like, these people always come and testify on everything. Mm-hmm. But as these voices get heard over and over again, they become the norm. We have noisy people saying things about liberty, and those things become the norm.
You mean in New Hampshire?
Yes, in New Hampshire. Around the country, God bless you. Good luck with it. I understand why people can't move. Believe me, I had every excuse in the book, too. But ultimately, if you want to see something different, you're going to have to do something different. And staying where we are is the same thing we've always done.
It's true.
Yeah, it's essentially a position of someone who hasn't been an activist and someone who is lazy, because we've put in a decade, more than a decade, into this project. Now, that doesn't mean that it makes it more valuable. I don't want to make it sound like it's sunken cost theory or whatever.
Labor
like,
theory of value. Yeah. No.
There's been a lot of work put into this project, and that's the reason why the Free State Project is the way it is. That's the reason why it's more successful than any of the competitors out there to it, because New Hampshire was the right choice. It won overwhelmingly of the 10 chosen, you know, the 10 options. There were 10 states at the beginning of the Free State Project. New Hampshire was chosen by a popular vote, and New Hampshire won overwhelmingly. And so the reason why is because it is already the freest of all of the states. So what a great starting ground for a project that's going to move as many libertarians as possible. It'd be great if all of them came, but I'd be happy with 10%. Mm-hmm. I'd be happy with 1%, heck, at this point. But, you know, to get thousands of people who are active, who are willing to do something, and you know if they're going to move across the country, odds are good they're willing to actually do something else. You know, if you're going to pick up your life and go somewhere for freedom or for the chance at freedom, you're the kind of person we want here. We don't want the kind of people who are just like, oh yeah, I'll post on Facebook and maybe I'll be free someday. You got to do more than that, and that's what the Free State Project's about. So come on up. Join the fun. FreeStateProject.org. We'll come back with more here in moments and tell you about what's going on in D.C. Will cannabis actually be legalized there? Apparently, even though Congress is trying to stop it, the D.C. government is trying to move ahead.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Extendovite is a 7-herb heart protection cocktail designed to support cardiovascular health, blood pressure, and cholesterol levels. February is Heart Month, and we at Heart Drop 2000 are having our Heart Month sale with prices from 6 years ago. Starting now until February 28th, you can purchase a 4-month supply of either capsules or liquid for only $125, including shipping and handling, to help you help yourself. So call now to take advantage of this one-time offer. To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822, or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. You can enjoy the features that we have. They're waiting for you there, and they're totally free. You can actually create the content, submit whatever you want right there via our Reddit-based system to the front page of the site. Other listeners can vote. They can vote it up or down what you've submitted. You can vote on things as well. So go there and get interactive for free at freetalklive.com. Now, we've got a new advertiser here on Free Talk Live, Cameron Hughes Wine. And we had the opportunity, Mark, to actually taste six of their wines.
Yes.
This was about a week and a half ago. We had this event here in Keene and brought some of the activists out and had ourselves a little wine tasting event. And it was...
I recommend buying the six bottle pack.
Oh, I didn't know they had a six pack.
Well,
that's
it's
cool.
You know, you're going to order in different sizes, and that they it just packed nicely in the box. It just fit really nicely.
Well, I mean, if you're going to ship something, you might as well ship more than one bottle. That
yep.
makes sense. But
especially at these prices.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing about Cameron Hughes. You're getting $70 to $100 bottles of wine for the average cost of $15. Now, the way they do this is Cameron Hughes actually goes to the best vineyards. And they make some wine that's a little bit more than they need. You know, if you're making a batch of wine, you're going to have some extra you just can't sell. So they sell it to Cameron Hughes. But the rule is that he can't say, it's from this vineyard. He can't reveal the source of the wine that he's getting. So therefore, he can sell this kind of high-quality vineyard wine at so-called bottom-of-the-barrel prices, if you will.
Yes. And bottom of the cask.
There you go.
Oh, is this the people who did the wine tasting?
That's correct. Cameron Hughes Wine. You can go to chwine.com, and that's where you can hook up with, by the way, free shipping if you use code FTL. So code FTL, like Free Talk Live. It's the only way to get free shipping on your order of wine. And click the microphone in the upper left-hand corner at chwine.com and try it out.
Yeah, it was really, really great. I couldn't say anything better about that wine.
If you like wine, I don't think you can be disappointed by this. I mean, I enjoyed it quite a bit. So chwine.com, code FTL for the free shipping. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. What is happening in Washington, D.C.? This is what I wanted to know, because when I was actually reading the Alaska story about Alaska's legalization that's gone into effect today, they briefly mentioned that in D.C., that legalization was going to go ahead, even though Congress was blocking it. And I was under the impression, I don't live in D.C. and I don't want to live in D.C., but the basic understanding I had was that every ballot measure and every measure by the city council in D.C. has to go before Congress in order for it to be allowed into law in D.C. And so what happened was, last year, they did go through with decriminalization. Congress let that slide in. But somebody got in the way of the D.C. legalization measure. And so here's a story from the Washington Post to give you more information. Although voters overwhelmingly approved legalization in November, Congress blocked the district the following month from enacting laws to regulate sales of the drug. D.C. officials, however, have contended that the congressional interference did not halt the voter-approved measure known as Initiative 71. However, Bowser's administration had remained mum on the issue since she took office January 2nd. Aides, this is the new mayor,
Aides say they said they were concerned that spelling out plans for enforcement earlier could have provoked further congressional interference. Speaking for the first time in detail about legalization on Tuesday, however, the mayor said it now appeared all but certain that a congressional review period for the initiative would expire Thursday without conservative opponents in the House moving to quash legalization outright. Bowser's office circulated a flyer explaining that explaining the law that said Initiative 71 would become law at 12:01 a.m. on Thursday of this week. House Republicans have said they believe Initiative 71 was blocked by the spending restriction in December. The issue could be left to courts to decide.
Mm.
Until then, Bowser and D.C. Police Chief Kathy Lanier laid out the contours of how district police plan to respond to the law's changes. As specified in the ballot measure, district residents and visitors will be able to possess up to 2 ounces of marijuana, about a sandwich bag's worth. Residents will also be able to cultivate the plant in their homes, up to 6 seedlings each, and up to 3 plants at maturity. Marijuana paraphernalia, including pipes, bongs, and rolling papers, will also be legal. DC police.
So in their home, they can have 3 plants, but what if there's 2 people?
Six seedlings, three full-on plants.
Yeah, 3 plants. So what if you have more than one person in the home? So is this 3 seeds per structure?
Not clear on that. I don't have the law in front of me.
Yeah.
But in theory, if you have roommates, then each roommate does have their own separate area. Probably you'd be able to have 18 plants if you had 3 roommates, would be my guess.
Maybe. Mm.
I would tell my roommates, grow it in your room.
What if my wife smokes too and she wants to have it on her side of the room?
I don't know. You figure that out. DC police will stop ticketing for possession, which last year was downgraded to a civil offense instead of a criminal one in the city. So again, decriminalization did go through. The department will also stop using the existence of up to two ounces of marijuana on a person, in a car, or in a home as rationale for investigating other potential criminal behavior. Police, however, will attempt to draw a bright line prohibiting public use, said Lanier. D.C. police will be instructed to continue ticketing for public smoking of marijuana, a ticket akin to drinking in public, punishable by up to 60 days in jail and a $500 fine.
I bet they really want the $500.
The new law will also not affect the... there are going to be a lot more people smoking in public. I mean, if people know that it's legal to possess pot, they'll be much less concerned about smoking in public, even though there are still going to be prohibitions against
it. I got to say, when I was younger and I smoked marijuana, I would smoke in public without any kind of, you know...
In Florida.
Right. I just wandered around with a joint in my hand. I just didn't
That's
care.
That's what I do in Keene. Even now that I've got suspended sentences, smoke where and when I please.
Well, Keene's a little bit different than the average place, I think, because we've kind of had some level of de facto decriminalization here due to your famous 420 celebrations, Rich Paul. And people who don't know what we're talking about, you can just go search freekeene.com for 420 celebration. You'll find all kinds of interesting video. So,
and if you're going to be in New Hampshire around April 20th, we're going to be out on the State House lawn smoking our brains out. Come on out and party.
Hopefully it's going to be up this year, too, because the last couple of years there hasn't been enough promotion in advance for that event.
And that's been me. The under indictment,
you've also
Rich,
been in prison.
Was very busy.
Yeah.
And this year we're working on getting a sound system. We're going to have other speakers besides me. I believe Erica Golter is going to be speaking
from Normal.
And I'm going to be looking for some other speakers.
Cool. We'll look forward to that. And I'm sure talk more about it here on Free Talk Live. Because isn't it a Monday this year? I believe it is.
It is on a Monday.
So it'll be perfect. It'll be on Tuesday.
Yeah,
and we'll
it
talk
was
about
Easter
it.
Sunday last year, which was inconvenient for a lot of people.
That's a good point. So the new law will also not affect the district's prohibition against driving under the influence of drugs. And anyone caught smoking marijuana in a car could face stiffer penalties on par with those for driving while intoxicated. The district, however, has no standard for how much marijuana constitutes driving while drugged. So assessing that will remain a judgment call for police. So there are still plenty of areas where the police can rake in the cash, mainly, people smoking in cars and smoking in public. The chief did say that smoking in public restaurants, clubs, or anywhere else that the public is invited to enter will remain against the law. So perhaps in theory, a private club would be able to get around that, but a bar, for instance, you will not be able to smoke cannabis in a bar. Further, the mayor said she would act preemptively to keep a new industry of so-called cannabis clubs from forming to fill the void created by Congress having prohibited the city from forming a legal marketplace, as Colorado and Washington state have done with strictly regulated dispensaries. Cannabis-related businesses from those states and beyond are scheduled to participate in an expo a few blocks from the U.S. Capitol on Saturday. At that expo, some business owners have said they plan to provide guidance to D.C. entrepreneurs on how to start clubs with membership fees and access to the plant similar to what occurs in Spain. Others said they may propose subscription services that involve access to marijuana products. And one D.C. business owner has already begun testing high-end catered dinners cooked in marijuana-infused oil. So I'm excited here. There's a little bit more from the story. This is awesome. If D.C. actually goes through with legalizing cannabis, it's all but over. It's Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBucks to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live, Washington, D.C., the last place you would expect to see cannabis legalized. It looks like they're moving towards this, despite Congress believing they've blocked it. The people in the city, work for the city of D.C., the mayor and others, have said, we're moving ahead with this. And there's another story about sort of the political wranglings going on, you know, behind the scenes, or not necessarily behind the scenes, but what's actually happening to, you know, what are both sides saying here? Because essentially it's looking like this may come down to some court battles based on, you know, some legal questions as to whether or not, well, is D.C. right or is the Congress right? Can Congress stop this from happening, or were they too late? Or, you know, we can give you some more of the details here in a moment. But this story from the Washington Post at WashingtonPost.com is more of a general story about what will happen. And they're saying that it could be as soon as Thursday when this Initiative 71, which was proposed, which, by the way, was passed more than 70% of voters in Washington, D.C. voted for this. This Initiative 71 will supposedly go into law at 12:01 in the morning on Thursday, meaning that up to two ounces of marijuana will become completely legal to possess in Washington, D.C. It'll also become legal for you to cultivate your own plants, 6 seedlings and up to 3 plants to maturity. More from the story here, the flyer distributed by the mayor. This is a new mayor, Bowser, which had an outline of the district casting green.
Unfortunate last name.
Like the Mario Bowser, you mean?
I was thinking of a dog. Mario's Bowser was named after, like, it's like a dog's name.
Okay.
Like Rover. Bowser is a sort of archetypal
dog name. The mayor sought to dispel worries that the district would be headed for an unregulated marketplace. One question read, is D.C. going to become like Amsterdam? Answer, no. Our law allows home use by adults 21 and over. Pot cafes are not permitted, and neither is the sale of any amount of marijuana. So, like Alaska's initiative, at least initially, the Alaska situation that just took effect as of today is that it's legal to possess, but you can't actually sell it. Yeah, you can grow it in Alaska as well. They will be licensing places that will sell it as of 2016, but for the next year, it's going to only be legal to possess it. Going on, Bowser said she would send emergency legislation to the D.C. Council this week to prevent pot clubs from forming. Aides said the intent of the emergency bill would be to prevent the formation of widely used workarounds in which businesses would use membership fees as a proxy for pot sales. Bowser said she was also forming a working group to tackle other issues that may arise with implementation and would initiate other legislation if needed. To the chagrin of proponents of Initiative 71 and its provisions for home cultivation, Lanier also said it would be illegal to grow marijuana on balconies, rooftops, and backyards. Lanier said home cultivation.
I wonder why. I mean, if
the children might see it.
A green plant?
God, the children.
I don't know, Mark. I mean, they don't want to let go of their control. They really don't. On one hand, yeah, they want to look like they want to be able to promote to the people so they can get reelected. Hey, I supported marijuana legalization. But at the same time, they still want to make their buddies in the police department as happy as they possibly can. So it's not like they're going to completely let go of all of the control.
Well, yeah. It just seems like visible marijuana plants, not that big of a deal.
Lanier said home cultivation of pot will only be permitted indoors. Adam Ettinger, head of the D.C. Cannabis Campaign, has lobbied for cultivation to be allowed in restricted outdoor areas of private residences, saying it would be safer and more environmentally friendly than home growers using powerful heat lights indoors. In a question and answer session with members of the D.C. Council, Lanier also went further than what Initiative 71 spells out, saying that only 2 ounces per adult would be allowed at private residences. The initiative said that any pot harvested at home could remain there, which could far exceed 2 ounces. It's certainly true. If you've got 3 fully mature plants, then there's a darn good chance you're going to have more than 2 ounces there.
So what do you have to do? Leave it on the bush until you're down below two ounces. You know, it could be that actually our enlightened fathers of of public policy forbade outdoor growing because they didn't want everybody's weed to get all seedy from pollen. So,
still, the police chief acknowledged that enforcing laws in private homes will remain a challenge, and the smell of marijuana or even complaints from neighbors may not be probable cause anymore to enter a residence and investigate. Lanier and Bowser also spoke at length about the complex challenges outdoors that will flow from the district legalizing marijuana in a city with a checkerboard of federal land. And yes, this is an important point.
Mm.
So if you are in D.C. or you're planning on being in D.C., whether on business or pleasure, I don't know why you would go there for pleasure.
Oh,
but,
man, there's a lot of things to see in D.C. Please do
yeah,
not
a lot
disparage
of ugly
the places
government buildings.
Thick with hookers.
God. You mean the politicians?
Well, though them and the other hookers that service them, you know, there's multiple tiers of hookers in D.C.
It's an ugly place. It's full of government. Go there.
You are so biased. We took Jack to he wanted to see the Natural History Museum, really into the, you know, changes, sort of evolution of humans right now. And we stopped off there. We found a place that would take the dog for a few hours, you know, a little boarding place. She had a great time. Jack had a great time. It was awesome. We had a nice lunch at a place. Yeah, DC, it's great. It's a great place to visit.
Yeah,
easy to get there from New Hampshire. Just go south till you smell it and then east till you step in it.
Although DC police will consider marijuana legal, more than 24 federal law enforcement agencies that operate in the city will be bound by federal drug laws that make marijuana possession punishable by up to a year in jail. Lanier said federal officers who make minor marijuana possession arrests can still process prisoners at district processing centers like they've always done on arrests falling under DC code. District officers will not process the arrests. So they're not going to block the feddies from coming into their police departments to do the processing of the arrests.
That'd be crazy.
But at the same time, the district officers will not involve themselves in it. So the risk here is that if you don't know for sure whether or not you're on federal property, you better be real careful if you're going to possess cannabis in D.C. because the Fed cops will be hot on you to arrest you for this, while the D.C. cops, not so much.
That could go either way. In Ann Arbor, when they decriminalized at the city level, the state police did not trouble themselves to come into town and hassle people. Bully for the Michigan State Police for that.
The chief said that since decriminalization, federal officers have made 30 marijuana possession arrests. The mayor and attorney general are meeting in the next day or so to sort out how such cases will be handled by prosecutors. U.S. Park police officers have jurisdiction throughout the district and are not strictly limited to federal land. Lanier said an agreement between agencies means park police will follow federal law on federal property and district law elsewhere.
Mm.
So the same officer may treat you differently based on where you are.
You never know what they've got up their sleeves either. Really don't.
That's true of a lot of things. Guns near schools, weed near schools.
The same goes for D.C. police, she said. When residents are found to have marijuana in federally subsidized public housing, D.C. police officers will not arrest, but federal officers and housing authority police might. On the dichotomy between potential local and federal prosecution, Lanier said, knowing your geography is important. She said, it should not be confusing for police, but it will be for residents. The confusion is not on the enforcement side, the chief said. D.C. police are beginning training for how to respond to the law, Lanier said, including training on what 2 ounces of pot looks and feels like. Officers, she said, would not carry scales. Officers are...
They can use mine.
Officers are also being given wallet-sized business cards to hand out summarizing what is and isn't allowed, along with health advice and a number to a health hotline. The card says, quote, you shouldn't use marijuana just because the local laws have changed. And indeed.
You shouldn't drink bleach just because it's not illegal.
Indeed. Look, the fact that these laws have changed doesn't mean that more people are going to start smoking pot. I think it's important to point that out.
There's a marginal group that will, but yeah. I don't think it's going to be a huge group.
Well, I think that initially you might see like a party, right? If marijuana became legal in New Hampshire, I doth pledge that I will blaze up with you guys, right? Like, and you know,
and we've already done that.
It's been a long time, Ian.
With thee. Yeah.
It's been a very long time.
Okay.
And yeah, I mean, you know, you and I have worked together for 12 years, Ian. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I mean, I think that a few people will have a party and then they'll go back to life as it, whatever it is.
Sure.
Then we should drop them off at the city limits and make them walk back.
At that point, it'll be legal.
So I think it's great news. I mean, D.C., the biggest government place in the United States, arguably one of the biggest governments in the world, that they may actually have legal cannabis come Thursday at 12:01 in the morning.
Wow. I hope all the Congress critters will smoke a bowl because those bastards need it.
There's more on the way here. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Coming up, some not-so-great news about what happened at one secessionist meeting in Texas. It was awful.
Mm.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit freeross.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit freeross.org. That's freeross.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, February 24th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.29 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,200 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $241. Antiwar.com reports in a rare public appearance, NSA Director Mike Rogers defended the agency's policy of putting back doors in American companies' technology, compromising much of the commercial software produced in the United States as well as numerous types of hardware. Rogers insisted he was confident that keeping NSA back doors in all this software would not ruin the international market for American products, even though some companies are already seeing declining sales for their compromised products. Rogers had no good answer for how to guarantee the privacy of Americans who the NSA aren't supposed to be spying on in the first place, but insisted that the NSA needed the access anyhow. Rogers went on to liken the NSA's capability to the early years of the nuclear arms race, saying the NSA needed to be able to guarantee mutually assured destruction with its ever-growing arsenal of powers. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports NSA whistleblower Edward Snowden said he wishes he had come forward sooner with documents exposing the agency's surveillance program. In a Reddit Ask Me Anything interview on Monday, Snowden said that's the one thing he would do differently in 2013 when he revealed NSA practices. Quote, I would have come forward sooner. Adding, had I come forward a little sooner, these programs would have been less entrenched and those abusing them would have felt a little less familiar with and accustomed to the exercise of those powers. This is something we see in almost every sector of government, not just in the national security space, but it's very important. Once you grant the government some new power or authority, it becomes exponentially more difficult to roll it back. Snowden participated in the question and answer session with Laura Poitras, a journalist and director of Citizen 4, Sunday's Oscar winner for Best Documentary, and Glenn Greenwald, a journalist who co-founded The Intercept with Poitras and journalist Jeremy Scahill. At Sunday night's Academy Awards ceremony, Neil Patrick Harris made a dig at Snowden, using the pun, quote, for some treason. Snowden said he wasn't bothered by Harris's comment. To be honest, I laughed at Neil Patrick Harris. I don't think it was meant as a political statement, but even if it was, that's not so bad. My perspective is, if you're not willing to be called a few names to help out your country, you don't care enough. Snowden then quoted 18th century politician Patrick Henry, if this be treason, let us make the most of it. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a Texas court on Monday halted next week's scheduled execution of convicted murderer Rodney Reed after backers petitioned a state court for a stay, saying he was wrongly convicted due to faulty evidence and unreliable testimony. The Texas Court of Criminal Appeals did not elaborate on its decision. Reed's backers for years have been questioning his conviction for capital murder and filed a petition this month with affidavits from forensics experts who faulted evidence used in the trial. Reed, who is 47, was scheduled to be executed on March 5th for the 1996 murder of Stacy Stites. Attorneys for Reed said Stites was likely killed by her fiancé, a former police officer now in prison for the abduction and rape of a young woman while on duty. The officer has denied the allegation by Reed's lawyer. Attorneys for Reed, who are seeking a retrial, contend evidence was altered concerning the time of the death to undermine Reed's alibi. They also said the officer was angry at Reed because he had a relationship with Stites. Prosecutors have said Reed was found guilty in a fair trial and should be executed. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A Japanese-American internment facility was still in operation in the mountains of Northern California. The facility should have been closed in 1945 and its 6,000 residents released, but unfortunately the camp was overlooked until this week. I am happy to announce, however, that the remaining 118 detainees have now been fully exonerated of suspicion of spying for General Tojo, and they have been freed. Next item of business. The president will be meeting with the Australian Prime Minister, Kevin Rudd. Yes, Denise?
Huge oversight. How could this have happened?
Well, Denise, it looks like the camp just somehow slipped through the cracks. The end of the Second World War was a hectic time in America, and it's only natural that we let a couple of things slip in our excitement over defeating the Nazis.
Who was going to be held responsible for this?
No, there won't. In fact, the War Relocation Authority was responsible for the decommissioning of the internment facilities, but that organization ceased to exist in 1946, so no.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome back to Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is available to you. You may dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, this show so far tonight has been full of great news, and I like it when we can talk about good news because there's just so much bad news in the world. It's refreshing when there's something pleasant to say. And it is. It pleases me to be able to say that Alaska is now the third state in the United States that has legalized cannabis. Not fully, but you know they're going in the right direction. They've got up to an ounce that's legal. That's effective today. And then also next year in Alaska, they will have dispensaries. You can also grow plants right now, today. You can legally grow up to, I think it was six plants, three of them fully mature in Alaska. Also, D.C. coming up Thursday. If everything goes as planned, Washington, D.C. will have legalized cannabis. And theirs is up to 2 ounces possession, up to six seedlings and three mature plants. There will be no...
It's the same thing.
Six seedlings.
Six and three, right?
Yeah, I guess that's right. Well, no, not necessarily, because in D.C.
They were... In D.C., it was six plants total, of which three may be flowering.
That's correct.
Is that right?
Yes.
So this would allow nine plants total, of which three can be flowering, I think.
Okay.
Six seedlings plus three flowers.
If you're in D.C., do your own research. This isn't legal advice. We're just reading the news here. So 2 ounces in D.C., plants allowed in D.C., but no sales. No sales in D.C. There's no plan for any dispensaries or anything like that. So it's not perfect, but it's pretty amazing that something like that can happen in Washington, D.C. And by the way, that's in spite of Congress trying to step in the way. And I've got a story about what exactly has been going on. Like, why is this happening the way it is? Because D.C.'s government is challenging Congress, basically, you know, calling them out, saying, we don't think what you've done has blocked legalization. We're going to go through with what the voters wanted us to do.
Well, first off, Congress shouldn't have anything to do with passing laws in Washington, D.C.
Generally, they don't. They've only used their power like three times in 40 years to block something. But technically, they can block anything that goes through.
The concern was, and the reason they were given that power, as I understand it, is because they were afraid that the city authorities were going to pass laws that, for example, would make it impossible for Congress to do its job somehow.
It blocked the roads, too.
Or, you know, it's the same reason that Congress critters are privileged from arrest while they're on their way to session, because they were afraid that local authorities would arrest congressmen who were about to make a vote that they didn't like. So, it's hidden in the arcania of the Constitution.
I suppose it's possible, right?
And of course, is D.C. mentioned in the Constitution at all?
I don't think it is.
I don't think it is either. It wasn't immediately going. Of course, the constitutional government first sat in Philadelphia, didn't they?
I think it's New York City.
Was it New York City?
Washington, D.C. was inaugurated in New York City. That much I know. Okay, Philadelphia, however, was, I believe, the largest city in the Western Hemisphere.
Well, Philadelphia was the capital during the Whiskey Rebellion. I don't remember when that happened.
Whiskey Rebellion was under Washington.
Was under Washington, so that would be post-constitutional.
Call BS on that one.
Okay, the reason I believe that is a... book that I read called The Probability Brooch.
Oh, yeah, I read that one,
by,
too.
By L. Neil Smith, and it talks about Albert Gallatin convincing the army that was sent out to enforce the whiskey tax in this alternate universe. He convinced them into turning around, marching back to Washington, D.C., and hanging George Washington as a traitor.
Apparently, I am mistaken. Philadelphia was one of the nation's capitals during the Revolutionary War, and the city served as a temporary U.S. capital while Washington, D.C. was under construction. So there you go.
And of course, I misspoke there. He talked about marching them back to Philadelphia to hang George Washington.
The capital.
The capital.
Houston Chronicle reporting. We can come back to marijuana legalization and sort of the conflict, what's happening in D.C., but a little bit of bad news for you here tonight. We, on this show, tend to be big fans of the idea of secession. I know I certainly am a big fan of that. Rich Paul, how do you feel about secession? Should we have it sooner rather than later?
It's got to be either secession or... proper enforcement of the 10th Amendment in order for the nullification in order for the Free State Project to achieve its goals. So I'm generally in favor of secession everywhere in the world too, yeah. Just on general principle.
I'm for smaller areas having more autonomy because I think that that gives you an opportunity to essentially be served by whatever governing body there is. And frankly, I think you should be able to sort of take your property and secede too, as long as you can, you know, get whatever the services are. I don't think you should be using a road that you're not paying to maintain. I don't think you should be getting, trash pickup from an organization you're not paying to pick up your trash. So,
well, I should be able to use a road if someone else wants to pay to maintain it. Like, let's say Goodyear wants to sponsor a road.
That's like saying that I think you should be able to listen to radio stations that advertisers sponsor, yeah, because you're paying for the listening to the radio station by listening to the advertisement.
I think it should be important.
This is why I stand against ad block on the internet, yeah, because so many sites are paid for by ads and then somebody turns off the ads.
Yeah, I just want to make it clear that when you say something like, oh, well, you should have to pay for the road, that's just one way to organize like free market roads. Another way would be sponsorships where you don't have to pay
for
anything.
I think it'd be a great idea if businesses, say, in town wanted to sponsor sections of the road and maybe they write on the road, brought to you by Walmart or wherever.
Absolutely.
Would they do anything to prevent ad block in your perfect world?
I think that somebody who makes a browser can choose to do that, or somebody who has a website can attempt to somehow foil ad block.
Sites that will foil it. There are certain video ads that will not run. Or the video, like if you click on a video with an ad block on, if it's set up the right way, the video that you're requesting, the one you actually want to see, not the ad, the video will not run. If you turn off ad block, then the ad plays, then the video you want to see will run. So there are some creative ways that they've gotten around it. Here's a story from Houston Chronicle.
I think that people have become too entitled when it comes to the internet. The fact is that everything, tan-snaffle, there ain't no such thing as a free lunch. And when, you know, businesses are paying, like they do on Free Talk Live, businesses pay our paychecks to keep us coming here, and then, well, you know, that's how it is on internet sites. And then when you put on ad block, yeah, there's too much of it. Some of it, you know, feels like it's going to give you epilepsy. Just don't go to those sites.
It seemed like a typical congressional meeting for the Republic of Texas. Senators and the president gathered in the center of a Bryan, Texas meeting hall, surrounded by public onlookers to debate issues of the national currency, develop international relations, and celebrate the birthday of one of their oldest members. You got to give these Republic of Texas guys credit, man. They have a well-developed secessionist movement.
They do.
Down there. But this wasn't 1836, and this would be no ordinary legislative conference. Minutes into the meeting, a man among the onlookers stood and moved to open the hall door, letting in an armed and armored force of the Bryan Police Department, the Brazos County Sheriff's Office, the Kerr County Sheriff's Office, agents of the Texas District Attorney, the Texas Rangers, and the FBI.
Speaking of unfortunate names, Kerr County. Right? Like it's an insult for dogs.
Yes.
It's spelled K-E-R-R.
Let's see.
In the end, at least 20 officers corralled, searched, and fingerprinted all 60 meeting attendees before seizing cell phones, all of them, and recording equipment in a Valentine's Day 2015 raid on the Texas separatist group. John Jarnicki, president of the Republic of Texas, says, quote, "We had no idea what was going on. We knew of nothing that would warrant such an action," unquote. The raid was a response, apparently, to legal summonses sent by the Republic of Texas members to a Kerr County judge and bank employee, demanding they appear in the Republic's court at the Veterans and Foreign Wars building in Bryan the day the officers stormed in. Jarnicki's group, the subject of a half-hour YouTube documentary, maintains a small working government, including official currency, Congress, and courts. Now, we've heard about this before on Free Talk Live, where people will call in and they'll say, "We need to make our own courts and send out our own subpoenas." You remember these calls?
Oh, yeah. This happens all the time.
Well, people say it all the time, but do they actually do it? Well, apparently in Texas, they tried that, and that got them a raid. We'll explain a little bit more about why that happened. What was the charge? Was there a charge? 855-450-FREE, or did they just steal everyone's cell phones? It's Free Talk Live. More coming up here in moments.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw-free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power, a gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
A hot new murder craze sweeps Chicago. Things that shouldn't be said in modern society are said 1,400 times at the RNC, and a brave woman enters a restaurant without first looking it up online. This is the Onion Week in Review. The World Wildlife Fund quickly backtracked Thursday from a recently released press statement saying panda ears are, quote, absolutely delicious. Organization officials noted that while panda ears do taste amazing braised, steamed, fried, or cooked in an omelet, they should not have announced it publicly, nor should they have ever eaten any part of a cheetah, giraffe, or Bengal tiger, no matter how good they may be. According to company sources, the Netflix board of directors held a tense series of meetings earlier this morning to decide whether the fantasy comedy Michael is streamworthy. The board reportedly sat through its mandatory two back-to-back screenings of the 1996 film starring John Travolta as an angel visiting Earth, all while passionately arguing over the film's story, acting, and level of enjoyment upon subsequent viewings to determine if the movie should be available through its instant viewing program.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Our Skype username here is lrn.fm. Feel free to reach out to us that way if you prefer. I would prefer it because generally
you will sound better if you're on Skype. And if you sound better, we might be able to keep you on a little bit longer. You never know. So again, Skype in at username lrn.fm. And ExpressCoin is where you need to go to get cryptocurrencies at a great price. Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, or wire transfer over at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the United States or in Canada, it is ExpressCoin.com. Plus, you can do it from your smartphone now by downloading their app at ExpressCoin.com. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL. You'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL. So we've talked about these, or we've talked to people in the past on Free Talk Live who have said, we need to create our own courts. We need common law courts where we can subpoena these judges and these prosecutors and bring them to justice by the people, because they're frustrated with the government one-size-fits-all monopoly court system, and they want to create an alternative.
This sounds like an even worse idea to me than sort of agorism, right? Like the idea that you're going to,
even worse than agorism, we got to come back to
this
that.
This is agorism, Mark.
No, this is not agorism.
Yes, it is.
This is, I would not call it agorism.
No, no. If you look at, what was it? I read Konkin's manifesto or whatever, the guy who sort of coined the term.
Well,
if
that
you
puts
will.
You up above 70% of the agorists. Go ahead.
I read it a long time ago, and if I'm recalling correctly, he had different phases of agorism. So, like, there was this phase where kind of people are just quietly doing business underground, and then over time, the businesses started to come out from the underground and start competing with the existing status quo, and including competing with the government.
That's true, but in Konkin's vision, before they actually tried to enforce their will on government officials, they become powerful enough to do so. And the Republican of Texas has clearly failed to notice this step.
No. I think you're missing something here. They're not forcing people to come to their court. They're just sending out subpoenas. They're saying, we, the Republic of Texas, are having court on this date, and we order you to show up, or something like that. I mean, I haven't read the actual subpoena, but it's not, they're not going to show up at the judge's house and put a gun to his head to force him to come to their court.
So, well, the question in my mind is there any language in their legalisms that they sent out that might imply that they would? Because if so, that it would be a threat to kidnap.
That's certainly possible, in which case maybe
it would explain the raid.
Well, no. I haven't gotten to the rest of the story here yet. The raid was done simply because they were doing what is called simulating legal procedure. So if you pretend like...
We did this in high school.
Well, that was a government school. It's totally okay there. but my point here is, to the point that this is agorism, is that the vision from Konkin, and I'm not signed on with this vision or anything like that, it's just my recollection, was that, yes, Rich, you're right, that up to a certain point, they're not powerful enough to compel the government to go into these courts. But at some point, the idea was to compete in the open marketplace, so create to create mediation services or arbitration services that would compete with the government court system, ultimately then out-competing them in the marketplace by allowing people to choose one of those options instead of the government option. So
see,
technically, this is kind of that.
That's certainly possible, although, he was talking about for-profit protection agencies eventually being able to protect you from the government.
Yes, that would be the ultimate. That's the final step, right? Where that essentially, that's like the fourth or the next to final step. Yeah. Where the final step is the government essentially becomes a band of brigands, and essentially disbands.
Have you read Konkin's newer book, An Agorist Primer?
I have not.
I highly recommend it. I handed it around a lot when I was in jail, and people seem to like it. It takes out some of the criticism and infighting stuff from the 1970s libertarian movement, which is in a new libertarian manifesto, and it gives a very nice view of agorism.
But do you see my point that why I'm arguing this could be agorism?
Yeah, I think you're right.
It's a half-assed attempt at something similar to one of the stages of agorism. I don't believe that the people who are engaged in it are actually agorists.
Oh no, I wasn't suggesting that at all. But eventually, if
it is similar to something that would be a stage of agorism.
Right. And so, and I think that, you know, and what we're seeing is what we predicted on this show is that as soon as you start to compete with the government, they get real serious and they start getting violent. They don't want you out there providing protection services. That's why they threatened the guys from Oath Keepers who were going around standing up on rooftops in Ferguson protecting businesses. The government threatened those guys over that. They also will go after you if you try to fix a road. You can't go out in most places and fill a pothole. That's illegal unless you are the government's contractor.
A lot
and
of times
so
you,
the same thing's happening here.
You can get away with pothole filling usually, but if you try to say paint a crosswalk on the road something like that, they will definitely come out and scrub that thing right off.
I'll tell you more about what happened to the Republic of Texas guys here in a moment because we just kind of got started on that. Steve, though, is on the line in Illinois. Steve, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Rich, Paul, and Mark. Steve?
Yeah, can you guys hear me?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah, this kind of off topic, but earlier this evening, or maybe it was this morning, I seen you guys had posted a video from a man from Michigan. He's going through child support issues. And
was this on our Facebook page?
I think this is the guy that this is the guy that apparently is liable for a child that is not his, and because this happens all the time.
Oh, the Detroit case. He's had the paternity test. It shows that it's not him.
And the first time he met the kid was at the paternity test. Because there's been a lot of instances where men have been liable for children that aren't theirs. But usually they've been the daddy. You know, they were there when the kid was born, or they were with the mom for a period of time or whatever. That their name got put on some paperwork. And then a judge says, "Yep, well, you paid for that kid for a period of time. It's yours now."
I think that's crazy.
Truly.
Exactly. But yeah, well, my best friend is going through the same situation and here in Illinois. And I was just wondering if there's any groups that might help him take that to the Supreme Court, because he has went through our local courts and the child has proved not to be his in the DNA. But the judge, you know, still said, well, you're liable because your name is on the birth certificate.
Yep. There are various men's rights groups out there that might be interested in that case. I don't know anything about them. I've avoided having children, so I didn't have to find out about how men are treated by the legal system. But I would check the men's rights groups.
Okay. You don't have any... like we can look up online or anything to send.
I can't
story
point or... you to any particular ones, but if you Google men's rights as
and
a quotation phrase,
your state or add your city,
add your state or your city.
That's what I would
recommend.
There you
go,
too.
Steve. Good luck. Thank you for the call tonight. It's stories like that that make me glad I have a vasectomy. The toll-free number.
Wait a second, Ian.
It's not
these are
his.
Guys that are.
He
you
could
know,
have a vasectomy.
Both of those cases, the gentleman said that you know, the paternity suit said that it wasn't his. A guy that lived with a woman would know that it wasn't his. And I mean, the vasectomy isn't going to help in this circumstance.
In the case of this parasite, poor bastard paying the child support, you are not the father.
Toll free numbers, 855-450-FREE. Still, it helps to have one, in my opinion. It's Free Talk Live.
Attention listeners, SurvivalLife.com is giving away free EverStrike permanent matches for a limited time only. These matches are waterproof and will light in any weather condition, rain, snow, or sleet. It will still throw a spark. Its built-in ferro rod strikes at 3,000 degrees, and it is good for 15,000 strikes. Normally, $15. Today, it's free. Get yours at freesurvivallighter.com. Again, that's freesurvivallighter.com. Hurry, supplies are limited. Visit freesurvivallighter.com today.
Good people need help. The Homeowners Association said we had weeds and fined us $25. We told them they had the wrong house. They said if we didn't pay it, they'd file a lien. Our attorney demanded photographs, witnesses, and told them if they couldn't provide this, they must cease and desist. Issue solved. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire.
The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Join us online over at freetalklive.com where you can win some prizes.
Yeah, you can get one of three $50 gift certificates to Corporate Sellout Clothing. They've got some really awesome t-shirts with some cool sayings on them. All you have to do is go to demo.freetalklive.com and fill out our listener survey. We've got some, you know, questions there. We'd like to find out more about you. You're going to have to give us your email address if you want to win the contest. It is optional on the survey, so you don't have to give it to us. You just won't win if you don't, but please go fill it out anyway. International listeners may win, but you'll likely have to cover some shipping costs. It's demo.freetalklive.com.
All right, toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype. That's where James in Arizona is. James, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, Mark.
Yes, sir.
Speaking of one digging his own grave, to quote Ian Freeman on Sunday night's edition of Free Talk Live, but I'm sure you didn't think he was talking about burying your family alive, or you for that matter. But I should like to respond to that shameless smear and you bringing up some one Ernie Hancock, the sucker he is in life as he shall be in death for sure if he doesn't repent and atone for his dope dealing for a living.
You sure are upset at a lot of libertarian talk
shows. You're
saying
Ernie Hancock is a dope dealer?
Isn't he the guy
who
did?
Minister Bernard, may I answer that question? Anybody like what he was doing this morning, which he's been doing for over 10 years, having children on that are convinced that the towers were taken down as a false flag operation to send the U.S. military into Iraq and Afghanistan for oil. May I tell the rest of the story, the true side of the story about his shameless use of the status to come knock on my door at 7:30 in the morning in September of 2006? Since you brought it up, Minister Edgington, can I tell the whole story without you hanging up on me?
How long are we talking about here?
Well,
the answer is no.
Well, you brought it up, didn't you?
That doesn't matter. That doesn't mean that you can monopolize the rest of the show.
What does matter, Mark? Hey, Minister Edge, why don't you listen to me carefully? What does matter is you accused me of a Minority Report crime that I'm going to commit murder against you and your family.
You
in
certainly
the future.
Talk about my death
and you
a
did
great
that
deal.
On national radio.
No.
Yeah, I
you're
said that you,
creepy
you
there,
did that
dude.
On national radio. I should like to respond to the other crap you said in addition to it.
Well, you can
By the
pick
way,
one thing to respond
pick
to.
Pick one
tonight.
Thing.
Yeah, and try to do it in 2 minutes.
Oh, really? I got some time limit on me, but you can smear me as much as you want after I. After
it's
you
not
my
your
dog.
Show,
That's
radio
the kind of man-
show, bro. You raging lunatic who talks about my death all the time.
Your death, what Catholics do is pray for our sinners. And if you don't repent and atone, when you do die, you will be punished for
well,
it.
You're you going, know, it's people then, like you that makes people think that religious people are psychos.
Right, it,
because you're quite clearly one. And, you know, I would think that religious people everywhere would be embarrassed to be associated with someone like you. So if you really want to do a service to your religion, maybe you should shut up.
That's fine with me if anybody wants to be embarrassed by my religiosity. You should be embarrassed by the two tax scammers you're sitting in between. But if I may
What,
continue,
they successfully avoided theft? I'm proud to be with people who successfully protect their property against theft.
James avoids taxes by not working.
Thanks for the call, James. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's the number. You can bring up absolutely anything, but you should focus. Focus like a lady. On the one thing that you want to talk about. James called first. He wanted to talk about what you said, Mark, or what I said, and then Ernie Hancock, and he's like all over the place.
Every time. I didn't like him. I didn't
when
like
have
him
you?
At
I mean,
all.
When has anyone liked James?
If James goes to, if James is going to heaven, I don't want to go.
Yeah, give me a reservation in the other place.
Wherever I get to go, the James is not.
Leo is in Montana. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Leo.
Yeah, I have a little bit of information for you.
Okay.
I think you need to learn a little bit why our courts are the way they are. I'm aware of, you remember the attorney that represented Randy Weaver?
Yes.
Jerry Spence?
Uh-huh. No.
He wrote a book that's called With Justice for None. And what he does, he goes back and he tracks all this out. Right back to the universities and how they teach it. Plus, it's the liberal bent that's in the air, why the courts are the way they are.
That really doesn't explain anything to me.
Is that what the suggestion is?
Hmm?
Is that the suggestion? Read the book?
Are you saying that it's because of the liberals? Is that what you're saying? It's because of liberals is why the courts are the way they are?
Partly. It's partly because of some liberals, and it's partly the way they teach lawyers in the beginning at universities.
You know, I will say there are some problems with the way they train attorneys. When I asked my attorney what was contained in the Ninth Amendment, you know, she didn't know. I had to give it to her by memory.
Mm-hmm.
And that was kind of strange because the Ninth Amendment says that, that the enumeration of certain rights in the Constitution should not be held to deny or disparage others retained by the people, which kind of implies that we have an infinite number of rights, and it seems like the sort of things that defense attorneys ought to know.
For sure. Now,
see,
Leo, go ahead.
See, the thing I faced was I had to go through a divorce, and then somebody told me, you handle it this way. I handled it, and I got a big payout from the other party. And also a girlfriend said, I'm suing you for my goods. And I just told the magistrate, hey, all she had to do was ask about it. I've learned how to handle some legal things along the way. But I just suggest that, you know, what he says in there, I've read part of it. I haven't gotten into it yet.
Well, there's a lot of problems with the court system, and I'm sorry, I don't believe that it has to do with the liberals or the conservatives or anything like that. I think it has to do with the fact that people in power, whatever their political beliefs, are going to aggregate more power to themselves. And if you look at you look at the court system's history, and thank you, Leo, for the call. You look at the history of it. They got rid of jury nullification back in the late 1800s. I mean, the Republicans and Democrats didn't even exist back then. So,
well, I would say that it was
there were the Democratic Republicans.
Yeah, but not like
the late
today.
1800s. There were definitely the Republicans. Lincoln was the first Republican, so there were definitely Republicans.
The Republicans and Democrats did not exist like today.
Right.
In the late 1800s.
But the liberals probably wanted the reason the jury nullification took such a hit in history. Is essentially because white Southerners who hated blacks were using it to get murderers of blacks off of murder charges. So I would say
technically that's not jury nullification, because they're not doing it because they consider the murder statute to be unjust, but because they're biased against certain defendants or victims.
Think that was the reason for it, Mark?
Yes, absolutely. Now, it was used decades prior to that, to go after, to release Northerners who helped blacks escape. So, I mean, it has a spotty history at best.
Is there evidence for that, or is that your speculation?
There is strong evidence that people were acquitted in lynchings when there was sufficient evidence.
No, that's not what I mean. I know that things like that happened. I'm asking, is there evidence for your contention that it was those acquittals that led to jury nullification being eliminated from, jury instructions and people being able to even talk about it in court and things like that?
I've read it in places. All I can say is that I would believe that there's correlative data as far as the timing goes. I don't know that there are memos going between judges that say that we have to get rid of this jury nullification thing, a thousand-year right of in English common law, because of these things happening. I don't know the answer to that. I would suspect the Southern judges probably wanted to see those people let go too. In a lot of cases, those are
I suspect they got rid of jury nullification because it's a threat to their system. It's a threat to the power that the judges would like to aggregate to themselves, and the jury nullification stands in the way of that. In fact, Rich Paul, you and I are board members on nhjury.com.
Then you really should look this up. You should know the history.
No, I don't need to know all that.
Like to learn the history. If I have time, I'll look it up.
855-450-FREE. There's more coming up here in moments. You can bring up what's on your mind on Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. We're here in the remaining moments. There's enough time for you if you dial in right now at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The Republic of Texas had a meeting raided by a multi-jurisdictional force. At least 20 officers corralled, searched, and fingerprinted 60 meeting attendees, seized all cell phones and recording equipment in the Valentine's Day 2015 raid on the Texas separatist group. The claim is that the Republic of Texas guys had sent some sort of notice, some kind of subpoena to a Kerr County judge and a bank employee demanding they appear at the Republic's court, which is stationed in the Veterans and Foreign Wars building in Bryan, Texas. The Kerr County Sheriff, Rusty Heierholzer, says, quote, "You can't just let people go around filing false documents to judges trying to make them appear in front of courts that aren't even real courts," said Rusty, the county sheriff.
I love the boss hog voice he did there. That was great.
How do you know it's not a real court? What is it that makes their courts real versus the Republic of Texas's court? Why is one court real but the other court isn't?
Because one court has more guns.
But still, by its basic construction, they've got a room. There's a man calling himself a judge. There's a person calling themselves a prosecutor. They've got a gavel. You know, why is that not real? It's as real as any other court. It's all just a play.
I think that it's pretty...
Does a guy wear a dress?
Possibly.
Okay.
Maybe even a wig.
If he wears a dress, it's a real court.
What if he puts on a wig? Would that make it more real?
They might wig out.
They're so these courts have they're basically cartelized, right? Like the
government courts.
The government courts, yeah, recognize the other government courts, and they say, "Oh yeah, these people are legit," and that sort of thing. What these other folks are, I wouldn't call them a court necessarily. They're an arbitration organization or arbitration group, and that's what they're proposing to do in this circumstance. I think the problem with the Republic of Texas is they're trying to be another government and another state, and I just have no use.
Well, that's what a lot of secessionists want, is they want their own state.
But you know as well as I do, I offer arbitration services right here for our little community.
Those are voluntary, and you're not sending subpoenas out to people.
If people come, they pay for the arbitration services, and I decide who's right, who's wrong, and who has to pay for it.
I'm going to bring Rob on the line here in Alabama via Skype. Rob, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Rich, Paul, and Mark.
Hey, good to be here.
Hey, Rob, go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah, I have been to several meetings with some of the common law judge courts here around in Alabama, and mostly as an observer. But
what are these? Are these the independent folks who are not connected with the state of Alabama or the cities?
Correct. They're individuals who have somehow studied some form of law. They have Latin law books and other legal texts that they use.
Where are you having this court? Is it in someone's living room? Did they rent a business space?
A lot of times they would meet like at a restaurant in a, you know, in a big room in a restaurant usually.
And what's going on? You know, what are you seeing happen in these courts? Well,
one I saw, and I really don't know what the outcomes of all these were, but one I saw was a man had bought a house, had a loan, and it was around 2009, around in there, and there was some kind of government program to delay your mortgage payments or something like that as part of this bailout deal. I don't know if anybody remembers anything like that. So that's what he had. And he had all his documentation, all his, you know, letters and communications with all these different agencies and people. And the bank had gone ahead and foreclosed on him and put all his stuff out on the street. And he had tried several different remedies. And, you know, they listened to all of his, looked at all his documents, listened to his story. They actually had a type of a grand jury there, and they were going to subpoena these people. I don't know whatever came out of that, actually.
How did you get invited to this thing?
Well, it was just through being involved with local liberty-oriented people and groups and just getting into the fringe elements of that. And, you know,
it's interesting. I'm interested to know that people are actually doing this, because we've always heard people talking about it, but it would
sounds more productive than spending your night watching TV. So yeah, okay.
Well, yeah, I mean, hey, I'm free. What else am I gonna do? You know, yeah, watch TV. Yeah. Well, here's another interesting aspect. I mean, these guys are also like no license plates, no driver's license.
Right. Right.
And roughed up all the time, you know, but nothing. The interesting thing is, and I know another guy up here closer to me who has been a freedom fighter in that area for a long time. He's in his 70s, and for years he's had no license plate, no driver's license.
Wow.
He just has a license plate that says private.
I love
They've
those
roughed
people.
Him up, thrown him in jail. It never sticks. He's out on, you know, he's always gets back out, but he.
I think those people are so brave, and I think we need to have a bunch of them move to New Hampshire.
I would love to have those people in New Hampshire show up for their events.
Well, there's actually, you know, quite an anti, under the covers, and maybe not so in these areas down here. There's, you know, I was just reading about some of the atrocities of the Civil War that happened down here. There is a strong anti-federalist sentiment, and a lot of people are like,
South will rise again.
One interesting thing about these guys, what they claimed, these judges, they claimed that they went after the bonds of different public officials down in the middle of the state, and that they were selling their cars and, you know, having financial
problems.
Those are
big claims, and you know, claims like that.
And I don't verify that, but that was a person who claimed to have done that.
Yeah, interesting.
The Montana Freemen did do that. They received some unwanted federal attention
for it.
They were putting liens on the property of public officials, and I'm quite sure they made those public officials very uncomfortable when they did that.
Thanks, Rob, for your call tonight. I appreciate the story. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Thing is, though, when you start sending out subpoenas, that's what happened with this Republic of Texas group. They sent out what appeared to be legalistic-looking forms to a judge and a bank employee, and then as a result, they got their meeting raided. The sheriff says he used a show of force. Group equipping officers from city, county, state, and federal law enforcement to serve a search warrant for suspicions of a misdemeanor crime. He said he had worries that some extremists in the group could become violent, citing a 1997 incident, that's more than 15 years ago, when 300 state troopers surrounded an armed Republic leader for a week-long standoff. Jarnicki, who's the current president of the Republic of Texas, said of the 97 incident, quote, "We've had years of bad press, but we're not those people. But yes, we are still making every attempt to get independence for Texas, and we're doing it in a lawful and international manner." Unquote. The Republic has a lengthy list of qualms with the federal government, among them that Texas was illegally annexed in 1845. But most of their complaints have to do with the behavior of the American legislature and the executive. Robert Wilson, a senator in the Republic, equated politicians in D.C. to the, quote, "kings and emperors of the past," and sees Texas.
Well, he's absolutely right, because yes. These people, this Texas, Republic of Texas, they have as much legitimacy as the First Continental Congress did. When the colonists got together, you know, they had their little elections of people. By no means did everybody vote in these elections. So they, sent people off to represent them or whatever. Mm-hmm. These were just people getting together and talking about stuff with legal theories and that sort of thing.
The 78-year-old pastor, Robert Wilson, said, quote, "This is the century for colonialist ambitions to be reversed. I've watched a lot of things happen, and the people of the world are fed up. The spirit of the world right now is make things smaller, move governments closer to home, take back self-rule."
Yeah.
Jarnicki said he was being taxed by a foreign government, and he feels doesn't represent him, and protested having to fund bank bailouts in foreign wars. Jarnicki said, quote, "According to the U.S. Constitution, the only place any army should be is guarding our own borders, not invading and trying to impose their will on every other country of the world." Still, he and Wilson said their group would not resort to violence, but is working through world courts to get international recognition of an independent Texas. They say their methods are legal, but Sheriff Heyerholzer contests that.
Jesus, what a name.
He says, quote, "We've had a lot of dealings with the Republic of Texas members in the past here, too, flooding the court with simulated documents. I don't have any problem with them going back to the Republic of Texas, but they need to do it through the proper legal channels." Unquote.
How the hell is the proper legal channel for Texas to secede? Come on.
The search warrant is looking to accuse people of, quote, simulating legal processes. They were authorized to seize all computers, media storage, software, cell phones, and paper documents. It's a horrifying story. There's a little bit more. We'll post the rest
really
of it.
It really is. Does the NH Liberty Party need to worry about this?
We're not sending out, legalistic-looking documents, so no, not at all.
I don't blame you.
We'll see you tomorrow night. Online in the meantime, freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network.
at LRN.fm.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Tuesday, February 24th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,193, down $10. Silver opened at $16.22, down 13 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $237.50. Today's precious metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. With civil unrest occurring all across the country, being food secure has never been more important. Visit eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, officials with the International Atomic Energy Agency have stated they will consider re-examining alleged evidence of Iran's nuclear capability after details of a CIA operation have been exposed. The CIA is accused of sending fake blueprints for nuclear weapon components to Iran in February of 2000. Court documents reveal a plot to plant the substantial piece of deceptive information on the Iranian nuclear weapons program. An activist with St. Louis Anonymous is currently facing 3 years in jail for five charges, including two counts of interfering with an officer following arrest in Ferguson, Missouri. Alex Poucher says he's being targeted for his role in protests and online actions by the Anonymous Collective against St. Louis police. In honor of the launch of the new and improved SovereignLiving.com, the Liberty Beat each day this week will bring you a simple survival tip that just might save your life. With today's tip, here's John Bush.
Maintain supplies and tools for lighting in a power outage. Power outages occur regularly, especially if you're in a part of the country with an antiquated electric system. Keep a plentiful supply of candles and matches around. Kerosene lamps are good to have on hand as well, but be sure you stock enough kerosene to get you through a lengthy blackout. Keep several flashlights around along with a solid supply of batteries. Flashlights are good to use when you need to navigate a dark hallway or check on your property.
The Liberty Beat is brought to you by the Free State Project. Want to find liberty in your lifetime? Then join thousands of others who are making the move to New Hampshire, the freest state in the Union. To learn more or to pledge to move today, visit freestateproject.org. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Tuesday, February 24th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The U.S. Customs and Border Protection has revealed which cities will begin pilot programs for body cameras. Cameras are being used in New Mexico, West Texas, Florida, Washington, Oregon, and Michigan. The cameras are being implemented in response to growing backlash to use of force by Border Patrol officers and agents. Since January 2010, there have been 39 deaths at the hands of the Border Patrol, with 2014 being the most violent year. The American Civil Liberties Union called for the agency to adopt the cameras as far back as October of 2012. Both the Houston, Texas Police Department and the Harris County, Texas Sheriff's Office are refusing to release details about their policies on how body cameras will be turned on or off. The Houston Chronicle reports the requests from both departments have been denied. The Houston Police have spent around $108,000 on 100 cameras for a pilot program and are seeking $8 million to purchase cameras for 3,500 officers. On February 20th, the North Dakota State House approved a bill that would allow the farming, production, and sale of industrial hemp. House Bill 1436 was passed with a vote of 87-5 and now moves to the state Senate. If the measure passes, it would effectively nullify federal prohibition on industrial hemp. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising.